Ain't that right? That right, Big Lisa, I stay focused, stay grinding. Ain't that right? What we gotta do, gotta keep grinding. Ain't that right? Then you gotta treat everything like it's a stump. You gotta keep grinding. Ain't that right? That's all right. They'll clap later when they see. Here's some more. Ain't that right? Two to be here. Two, I know some of them couldn't be here. We certainly put live for them and the Johnson family. They wanted to be here. And Martinez, he had a little sniffles. He went and checked out. He had the COVID. So that COVID had to hit him. The Johnson family trying to get here. All the three of them got hit. It was one, two, then three. You know, I do the knockout. It's still out here. One thing about it, so is Mr. Yahuwah. I'm giving all. I'm Shakar. I Shakar the one. I adore and worship the one who been here before any disease, any sickness, and there before any man, any animal, any waters, anything was established. He was him. He the best man to serve. And then right, get somebody who was him before everything was. The person when he came, I brought it. Isn't that right? To establish his position so everybody know where he stand there. Everybody talking about what a loving Elohim and what a tube Elohim is. He also Elohim is his word. It's the bond, which meaning what he say he'll do, that's what he'll do. If he said it, he'll do it. Isn't that right? It's the our benefit for us to yarra him and be willing to do everything it takes to stay out of the wrath of Elohim. Isn't that right? And understand when he allowed things to happen, and not because he's against us, it's just so he can test us. Isn't that right? Every now and then he want to see where we at. When the word come, want to make sure we'll move, we'll be prompt about it. Y'all got it? When you got a man, you realize whatever decision you make is all in the hands of him, and the outcome of every situation is hand. He controls every outcome of every situation. Then you'll start to yarra him and fear him, and you'll start to harbor him and appreciate what he gives you. Because you lay down don't mean you got to get back up. That's an old wives' tale, I guess, that people say, that you believe that he got to get you up. If you leave in the morning, you got, like people say, I got to be back home by 6 o'clock. Did you talk to him about that? Somebody made an appointment for 1 o'clock Sunday, well, Monday morning, and 8 o'clock, and 9 o'clock, and all these different times. He just look at, it'd been good if somebody talked to me, because I'd have let him know you ain't going to make it. I got you marked absent. So I appreciate the fact that I had a card somewhere in there. Did I leave it on the table out there? I think of it, yeah, something. He got a card out there somebody sent. Got to see that card, see what they're talking about, too. I'm going to let our announcer read. She can read it later, but I know I had it out there. First thing I do when I open my letter, I'm feeling for money. That moved my spirit. Word's good now. That money do something to you, though. It's a check. Ain't that right? Cash is just a tad bit heavier. Ain't that right? Depend on the numbers. Y'all know all them bills ain't the same. Got different weight, different design. You got to know how to feel it. Y'all know how many of y'all know how to do that? That's a blind man trick. Feel that feeling. Yeah. Well, anyway, we appreciate Mr. Yahuwah. As y'all know, the world ending. Ain't nothing changed with that. We just got to make sure we on focus and make sure we got it right. That's our goal. We go through here and look at the ball and making sure we where we need to be. For all of us, because it's winding up. And you don't want to take this thing lightly and you get caught on the outside of it. How many of y'all, how many of y'all really think about it daily? Honestly, don't be down. I'm thinking about it now. I'm telling you, you got to think about it to enough that you consider, really consider your time, your day's number. Everybody in here. You don't know what disease, what sickness, what illness, what just natural cause. He might just say, don't get up, that he gonna cause to come on you. It ain't about an age, it's about the man got a time set aside for every one of us. And the thing is, we all sit around and we don't know when he gonna say, that's it. So the best thing we can do is make sure we write. Y'all got it? That's the goal. We go through the book. We wanna make sure we get understanding. We wanna examine this thing, make sure we got clarity with it, and make sure we can walk thereby, well, halak thereby. Y'all got it? And those words are beautiful. the Aubrey word, but we want to get more in depth into what we're doing, an understanding. And I think we need to understand it from the English grammatics, and then we need to understand what he's trying to tell us so we can compare. The book said comparing Ruach things with Ruach anything. How you going to compare Ruach anything if you don't have them? If you don't know them, you don't know. Because there are some things that actually is Ruach to be discerned. You can't discern it with the natural man. That's a thing you have to discern that's actually Ruach. Y'all know that? Okay. How many of y'all understand that? Let me see the hand. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9. How many of y'all holding off before you move too fast? Yeah, them the one that's smart. So they don't want to get in that throw. The other one, that y'all be wrong now. And y'all be sitting up folks and say, you just throw your hand up. Somebody had their hand up. Ain't nothing wrong with not knowing. You just want to know what's right. Yes, ain't that right? That's the truth. Listen, Christianity had aligned ourselves a long time. They had us in fear of a lot of stuff that we shouldn't have feared. We should have been fearing Elohim. They gave us prepositional phrases and other stuff and other things. We got four men ran stop signs, dumbass, done called the police and told on themselves. Gave themselves because they wanted to be honest. But you've been committing kata. Right. Won't you go kill your damn self? Because the wages of kataim is sin. It's moot. Oh, I know they don't be on that shit. Don't impress me. Go call the police and tell them, write them a ticket. They rent past a red light. Once you let Elohim know what you've done wrong, go ahead and kill yourself. Let him give you the fine and the penalty for that. See, that look good on paper with man, the stuff you try to pull and do. He look at that. He wants you to be right with him. That stuff they got, that's their stuff. Y'all got me. That's their stuff. You ain't gonna burn no Sheol cause you went past no stop sign. How you gonna do? What charge the tourer got that gonna take you out? You know what I'm telling you? You know how many times we done convicted? That be honest. How many of y'all felt you did? You like, man, I was wrong. How many of you felt like that? They tell the truth. I wanna. What? All right, in order to charge you with cartoon, with sin, Qatar, where I'm gonna get it from? Right. What verse we gonna use? Yeah, that's what I thought. I don't folks get you every time. That's going to be true. You could have gave it to Mordecai when he wouldn't bow down. Let's go with, I know what some of them thinking, running to Caesar with Caesar. When they set the man up, when they set, what that bastard name? Amon up, he was selling almost like Caesar. Everybody supposed to give reverence to him. Mordecai didn't do it. Why he went charged with Qatar? Because he told you why. Our Torah diverse from anybody else's Torah. Y'all know that? Our Torah more diverse. Now, I think about it today. I was talking, I had to talk to my insurance agent about some stuff. I don't know how many of them folks I got. But anyway, they were talking about the January the 6th. I sent out and told y'all to watch. I know most of y'all weren't going to watch it. Cause that's just, I know you don't want to watch it because you don't want to. You're too busy. You're too spiritual. I love them people. You know, I don't want to know what's going on in the world, dumbass. That's crazy. Why you don't want to know what's going on around? It affects you. That stuff, O-Tay, that's stupid. I need to know what's going on around me. I live here. I need to know these crackers holler, everybody grab a nigga. I need to know where I'm at. Isn't that right? I'm doing that. I need to know a bunch of white boys running, but ain't coming to give me no prize. But anyway, you know, try to watch them. And you know what, Kim and white people, though? They still patriotic. They still Americans, no matter what they do. They got to get the Constitution and the fair trial. They send everybody else at the Guantanamo Bay, though. You know, white people, ain't nobody did more shit get their country than white people. They look tired, rankly ass. The main damn folk, stand up for this country. Damn ass tore it up during the Civil War. Why your ass wasn't standing up then? They walk around with another flag. They named the damn army base after a rotten, white, old, tired ass Klan bastard that they fought against. Ain't nobody more hypocrite than white people. Ain't nobody done more damn in America than white people. Nobody want to talk about it. White people ain't shit. That man, they ain't shit. They ain't good shit. Let's be honest. Who done did more damn they couldn't than white people? They ass just tore up January the 6th. They still, then they going to sit here and they sit in the prison yard and they let these tired ass crackers get out here and pledge allegiance to the flag. I'll slap shit out of them. How you going to pledge allegiance to the flag? Your ass don't even believe in it. And ready to run behind us telling our ass to stand up. Stop with this country. How many people are dead? Tired ass. Y'all, I want y'all to watch January. So I want to just see what kind of piece of shit they are. And we've been scared of them. We always think they more American. Them flags don't mean shit to these people. Whenever they don't want to do something, they show you. They'll break ranks in a minute. America, whatever they call it. They tired ass. They can't stay on one side of the line or another. And then you got other tired ass white folk. They sit here and watch them show evidence, prove the stuff to them. They cut some information out. Sure they did. You think they cut information out of that stuff? You watch these people on real time, tired ass, sitting here telling you, oh, it's going down today. Y'all gonna see, y'all gonna be surprised. Yeah, they have no idea they're gonna tear that bill. They know damn well they were gonna do. Well, think about it. What the hell are you coming for with shields for? You put out here protest. If niggas popped up with sticks and shears and hammers and wood and nails and all the shit, you know damn well they finna get us out of there. They knew what they were gonna do. Tired ass Donald Trump, little wrinkly ass. Anyway, he done got all these folks shook. These folks love Trump. Trump ain't done shit for nobody but a tired ass white self. He done shot to hell every business he ever had. Hell, he ain't got Miss America no more. He don't do it, he just shoot shit in there. He tired as hell. These white folks, you know how he get his money? Making people think he could do something. That's how he rip them. Flat lie. You see them folks told you. Everybody around him told him. Ain't no election been stolen. His own attorney general, that's the highest law enforcement officer in the land. Y'all know that? There is nobody over the attorney general. He is the highest law enforcement officer in the land. And you know he told Trump when Trump told him about it? He said, bullshit. Maybe he told him flat. He said, bullshit what you trying to do. He said, ain't no election been stolen. You can't prove it. They got a federal judge. Y'all saw the federal judge. They showed it. Coming, he looked over it. He said, they need to be tried. He said, they knew what they were doing. He said, they tried to overthrow America. Soon as Black Lives Matter come out saying, don't kill her, we terrorists. That's the shit make me mad. No guns, no nails, no hammer, no hang Mike Pence, no kill the Senate, no kill Nancy Pelosi. Our ass going to jail, we're on a federal investigation. That's for you walking saying you don't want to get shot. These lying ass tired crackers done drug they stinking ass in here and tore the place up, they still patriotic. That's because they really love this country. Just tired of getting blamed for shit. They don't put something up here. Everything we do, we go into shit. You know, they gave us that premise, everything we do, we going to burn in hell. Why they don't burn in hell? They'll go and name their organization Hell Angels. The angels from hell, none exist, because angels don't exist, neither do hell. White folks ain't scared of that. Saint Knights. They go get these satanic shit. Blow shit out their mouth, all worship to the devil. These folks don't do them a play game. These folks not serious about nothing. They make a fool out you. And we be the main folk, princy, prince, scared of shit, walking around, scared stuff, going to have all your fears come from your enemy. And we scared to tell them. That's what pissed me off. We scared to tell them. They punk us out, scare us out, come grab us, snatch us out. Them white folk got all kind of attorneys fighting for them. They got all kind of deals they going to get cut. Trump told them, I get back in office, I'm going to pardon all of them. Why the hell they don't pardon none of these people that are locked up? They could have pardoned Tookie Williams. Shakur? What's his dad? His stepdad? Offended his mama. Offended went in jail. Stop it, man. His mama ain't in jail. His mama got in jail while he was still praying. He was in the spirit. Don't worry about him. I know he one of them. He's in the spirit. What's it? Atula. They could have pardoned Atula. They could have pardoned Mandela way years before that. That man spent 28 years in prison. Tired ass crackers. What bad the tired ass crackers behind is still living. They ain't all dead, they still living. Dick Cheney was the reason why he stayed in jail so long. Y'all know that? Dick Cheney was Secretary of Defense. What the hell he had to do with it? When these folks met, they were going to look at Nelson Mandela out. He told them no. That's how much power America got with some shit ain't got nothing to do with them. All the man was doing was fighting against oppressive white government in Africa. Wasn't even over him. That show you how long, what the allegiance of all these white people, their allegiance is to them. They don't give a damn whether they connect and state and don't disagree. They all united in keeping your ass down. That's right. And all are divided. Me and Cam couldn't agree on this damn seat right here together. White folk, well, they don't know they don't like each other. Know some shit. But we can come together just to hold your ass down. I'm tired of them. Take all the bad ones, put them in there and drop them off in some fly shit. I don't want them in nothing that's gonna help them. Drop them off somewhere, I'm just sick of it. Just sick of how we get treated. It's just deplorable every day. Listen, it's real every day. I struggle real every day. Even if they ain't grabbing, hell, we know you're coming. Can you imagine you live every day, you know it's just a matter of time for you. You got to run into them eventually. A traffic stop or some situation, you got to run into them. And you know what? You damn near already know what the outcome is going to be. They can tell that lie. They were, oh, no, that's a lot. You're going to have to run. You got to cross them eventually. So now how you got to live your life? Stay out the way. Fly under it. The hell we flying under for? Hell, we've been under all our life. You can't say nothing that look offensive. We need to come together. That's racist right there. Anything we say racist. Look how they done punked everybody out of Black Lives Matter. They locked up one woman who they accusing, who took money. Let me see. Nonprofit organization, she started, they give the money. What the hell the problem is? Let the people who in it that don't support it, that ain't what you want. How the hell did it become a federal issue? I don't give a damn about it one way or the other. But why the hell they got involved? You know why? That made everybody up black run away from it. That's how they destroy us every time. They made everybody get away from it. Y'all know that? Man, it's crazy. Y'all know they meet now about what happened with Latrice Lumumba back in the 60s. What back about the 70s? 60s, they killed him before Kennedy. Y'all know how many of y'all know about Latrice Lumumba? Lumumba. What the hell with that? Baboon. I know everyone can say it. Look, he actually was the first elected Democratic prime minister for the Congos. He was the first elected. That's what they had. Them crackers killed him. You know who was trying to get in there and trying to protect him? JFK. John Kennedy tried getting out. You know them crackers killed him, Jeff. They finally let, they killed him before he could get in office. And they kept it away from him for 3 months. He got out, he didn't even know he was dead. He was trying to get, he wanted to try to protect. He knew they were gonna kill him. They don't like black people, they're gonna stab him and do something. Y'all can look at video of them grab his ass, have him hang. Oh, they dirty. These some dirty crackers. Belgium done come on down there and brought their little tired white ass, little wrinkled ass over there. Cause Africa meet with them. They want some money for this shit. They looking at man, they looking at how they done messed them over. All these millions of people. Oh, what that little Leopold, another tired ass crack. I dig him up and shit in his mouth. I don't care if it ain't but a skull. I make it run out his eyes. Yep. I take 5 lakhs to the back, I shit all in his skull, just shoot out his eyes.
That's right.
Send it to his kids, his great grandkid. Sorry, bastard. He the one maimed all them black people. I hear him work. How the hell you talking about how fast I put? Get your little tired ass out here and show me the speed. Cut your arm off. Can you imagine that? Cut your arm off on the spot. And now you got to work fast. Them folks were busting ass with one arm. Think about it. Your arm been cut off, your hand? And you tell me now I got to work faster with one hand than I was with two? White folks ain't shit.
That's right.
They let this shit go. They could have been done something about this shit. Every time we look around, one of us get killed, then the shit come up years later. Let's talk about it now. When everybody dead, they could be prosecuted. You know, the hell we so passive. When they snap one of y'all ass and kill you now, then y'all will be all right then. Think of how many of our people that had to sit back. Your kid, you know it. You look at the evidence of this shit. Just like, what's the young girl up here they kill in Kentucky? Breonna Taylor. Can you imagine being her family member, her brother, her daddy, her sister, her grandma, her, you looking at this shit. You looking at shit, these folks done sat here and say, your daughter was a kingpin drug dealer and she was behind the killing of another guy. All this shit false. She was shot from outside while she was in her bed, sleep, naked, gunned down while she was asleep, and nobody get charged for it. It's summertime. Nigga worry about some damn Juneteenth. Let all that tent shit go till we get everybody free.
That's right.
It's retarded to celebrate it when your ass ain't went nowhere.
Right.
White people, you done that, man, you need to celebrate Juneteenth. Hell, I'll do it soon we get free. Anybody gonna throw no damn party harder than me? That's crazy. My ass sitting in prison and solitary lockdown, you gonna have a freedom party. You like a damn fool. I'm pissed. In the words of my grandbaby, I'm pissed. That don't make sense. I don't know, man. Maybe y'all just cut from a different cloth. I'm just pissed. Just tired. Just tired of going through the same old shit every time you look around. It's the same old stuff. We waiting around for another black shoe. Now these schools get shot, some white kids, or something look like white. They want to start taking shit from other folks. Why don't we take all these damn guns when black folks are getting shot? Why we ain't need no gun control and they were blowing our damn brain? Before, we needed gun control when they were killing with George Floyd. Right. Yeah. We need to get rid of white folk knees. Right. I want to pass legislation, no white police have knees. Too many niggas dying, and no elbows so your ass can't choke nobody. Let put that bill on the docket. Well, that's not practical. That ain't practical. You talking about taking everybody a gun. Get the gun from the damn weirdos. You know who they're white folk. What the hell are these little kids doing with guns? I told them, these fuck, get a competency test. What you do with that gun? They pill started to slap shit out. Get your ass out of here. I didn't be in them gun shop. What you want? What you looking for? Gun or what? Get your ass out of here. I ain't gonna start. You can look at folk eyes. Son of a fuck, look at the eye. Yeah, look at me and know already. I don't need no gun. You damn skippy. Get your ass out of the property. Ain't that right? Give me one of them virtues. I can look right in their face and tell them, hell no, you need to get your ass out of here. White look crazy as hell? No. Like a damn serial killer. Get your ass. Hold it. So what it is? Serial? Damn straight. Get out of here, killer. I see your ass a mile away. I seen a white man come there one time. That joker had a case. Look fat ass, he would look crazy hair, clean, look crazy, he walking like that him. He opened that gate, I'm telling you what, he had some shit. He was shooting, he had to lay on the damn wall. He long range shooting that shit. I said, damn man, that gonna kill somebody. I said, folks, what the hell you shooting way down there for? Who the hell you trying to shoot? Me, you need to learn how to shoot. Listen, most of y'all there need to shoot for about right here. Ain't nobody asked you finna shoot back at that wall that you finna get your ass away with. Stay your ass home. You need to do all that. You need to get the hell on somewhere. Ain't no room in between. Y'all know that shoot. I'm trying to shoot. Trying to say I can shoot from him, Pad Kroger. Get your ass out of him. You know how many damn folk walking between them? Set your nut ass down. I know these folks trying to get this shit all in, trying to shoot way down those street far. I'm looking, if I got to shoot, I got to get them to. Oh, no, I'm sorry. I don't want him to fall. I'm sorry. I missed you sleeping. Let me borrow something. We need to be by a little too close, a little bit more back there. That about there, right about there. Right about there. Now, this is the problem they're going to get. Let me come up for a second. They're going to tip it where he was standing in front. Let me see him. No, come here. So, what? No, right here. So, right about there, they might say it's too far. Where you really need to be is come up like two, right about right there. So, what I'm going to do when I shoot his ass, I'm going to run behind him right quick and push his ass over there. Now I'm going to come back on him. I said, he was up on me. Now, you got to move quick now to do this. You got to pop and run behind and push it, then jump in front of him right quick. They're like, shit, you ain't have a choice. He was right up on you. I said, I'm saying the same thing. Y'all all right? White folks ain't going to be that general. Now, they've done that shooting way down the street. That sniper shit right there. Let me tell you something. It's good you want to just do some shit. Like I'm just being it ain't practical. Ain't nothing you shooting out here, around out here, but people try to do all those shit. I don't have time to be shooting no shit way down no street. Everybody needs to shoot, need to see the white of your eyes. You ain't got no white eyes, I'm gonna take some paint with me, and I color all this shit up him. Color the outside part of him. So I didn't know one thing, that's how you came up. Do y'all want to protect the class or not? I know Fort Hurt, they went by. I just ain't for all that shit. I ain't got no bullet be shooting down on the street for no 4 and 5 miles. Shoot a mile and a half bullet. What the hell, who I'm gonna shoot a mile and a half? That damn thing get to sink it down through there. Man, you don't know who walked across that, your ass going to jail. Everybody you shoot ain't intended to be shoot, you got another charge on you. Stay within your little range. Don't be going out wasting all that paper trying to shoot all back down. That's all cute and pretty. I'm not impressed with that shit right now. You're inside a building, you ain't getting no real wind or nothing to take the velocity of that shit and move it around. So it's not practical in the first place. You're going outside and do all that shit you want to. If you ain't deer hunting and trying to kill to eat, get your little range you need to get. Go by 10 feet, something like that, 15 feet probably the most. Out of that, I don't have time for all that. I'm not impressed with it. Ain't nobody gonna take me nowhere and take me down there and try to make me sharp shoot down from him for no damn Kroger's. Now, did y'all have to shoot from here to Kroger's? No, I'm trying. 300 and more, that's called you shooting folks. On the street right here, you ain't shooting nobody like that. It's just not practical. A lot of time folks try to steal military, try here, ain't even been military. It's a waste of time. Stay within your range, learn how to shoot right here. That's how a nigga go to jail. Then you want to twist your damn wrist, be all cute, shoot like this shit all back around here. Turn your ass around, hold the damn gun right, and shoot the damn paper, and kill your ass on home. Be wasting up all them damn bullets. I have 6 box of bullets. Get your ass out of here, you been here too long. Bullets high as hell. Get your buck, get your one, know what you shoot, get it done, get your ass on out of here. All that gunpowder getting your nose, be smelling it, time to go. Y'all all right? Get your hearing aid and shit. Most of y'all shoot your ears out anyway. This ain't gonna help y'all out. How many of y'all wanna go shoot? How many of y'all wanna go shooting platinum? Y'all know. We're taking our me and Rod. He shouldn't have no objection. Yeah, we take y'all out there. We'll take y'all. He's looking around trying to examine y'all. Y'all fine. I take y'all out there. We'll do it. Put that paper right there in front of you. I'll be fine. Take y'all out and get them going. These folks sitting here, they got all these little crazy ass kids in here shooting. Y'all need to learn how to shoot too, to defend yourself. That's the truth. Black folk don't even go no gun. We just sit by the gun and just hope it works. Need to go and learn how to use your gun. You had a right to have one. Ain't cause white folk told you. You need to have your one. You need to know how to use it in the event you have to use it. A lot of y'all got your ass going to freeze up and you ain't going to do nothing. You need to know how to use it. And I already have the side in your mind. Your ass it is. For all of y'all that's scared to shoot, think about it. They get a hold of you. You think they're scared to do something to you? Matter of fact, you too damn bold. Why are you going to come up and kidnap me and grab me? Y'all are wondering, will somebody come up and rape you and kill you? You'll come up missing. So at that point, think about what, this person coming to grab you, what's their real intent? Maybe they just want to hug the shit out of you or something? That person get you, take you away, and hurt you and never see you again, your kids, your wife, and nobody else, or your husband. Not your wife. A woman shouldn't have no wife. But y'all need to consider. I know a lot of y'all, y'all need to go. Y'all need to learn how to protect yourself. Stop just having to tone around here and got all that titty juice in it. Damn thing, all up on it, deodorant all in the damn thing. Y'all need to learn how to use it. Shoot the damn man. He be like, ooh, that milk taste good. It'll be a bullet. See, white folk train their people. They teaching their people how to protect themselves. Y'all know that? And they'll try to act like they're trying to protect themselves against us, but white people trying to protect themselves against white people. Black people ain't messing with white people. White people messing with white people. Them people that came and stormed the Capitol, them were white people. Y'all saw that? And then look how the police just took an ass whipping from them. They laid them out. They had to drag them out. Damn, I'm tired of being out. All these ought to ignore it. Are y'all coming? Let me see. 12 of these bullets in y'all ass. Well, they start saying, hell, I ain't running for nobody with no gun. That's crazy as hell. Don't shoot. Man, cut that radio off. You crazy as hell. These folk got pole knocking hell out of me. They drag me, whooping the hell out of them. They slanging their ass at thorns of them. And they tell them, you ain't shoot. Get out. Stand out. This our country. You won. Who next? Drop that. I'm telling me, hell no. Listen, I take me to jail. Damn, I'm going to be scrubbed out with a gun on. Shit, you mean scrub me on no damn ground? That crazy as hell. Man, don't even think twice. I ain't finna take no ass whip with no gun. You ain't finna drag me across no ground. That's crazy. But look how they, you see how much restraint they got when white people whipping their ass. How many of y'all watched the video when they was short? Did they take ass whipping?
Yeah.
They got a cop down. They used a man down. Their ass will be coming like this. It's all blow us away. That show you they ain't shit. They'll let up. They got restraint for white people. That's what pissed me. I don't know how you got restraint. Y'all overmarked. You got damn at least 15 to 1 of y'all ass. How the hell you sit here y'all ain't shot one bullet? And the one man that shot, they look at charging his ass. He was black. That's my brother. He got off. That's my brother. That's my man throwing. They tell me he shot through the door. She an American hero. Well, give her ass a flag and put in her coffin. I saw her. She was a criminal when she came in here. Put a flag in a coffin. Hell, you stand outside that door, you trying to break through that door. They folk hired to protect these people. Y'all come with some bullshit like this? Man, please. But the fact that Senator them were pushing for this man to be charged, he was protecting they sorry ass. The same tired ass white folk he was protecting were looking for him to be charged for that. That woman is called shit. They said she was an American hero. She fought for this country. Never give up that. You'll never get it. Y'all go ahead and love the hell out of these white folks. Go ahead and serve them, kiss their ass now. They don't give a shit about you.
Nope.
They don't give a shit about you. Look how everything gonna be oiled and done. Them people ain't gonna get no real time. You got a man already hollering, I get in office, I'm gonna pardon every one of them. They ain't got nothing but hope. Senators, Congress people going here to visit them in prison. How many of them went to visit them people in Guantanamo Bay? You know how many police out here resigned their job, mentioned they are messed up for them ass whooping? The fact that they were ordered not to shoot them, you got to take this ass whipping. But nobody can't order them not to shoot us.
That's right.
No, we ain't even whooping your ass now. We got pulled over. Bam! How you restrain yourself when your ass getting whooped, emotions everywhere, tension, everything. How you keep yourself you don't pull your gun? How do you do this? That show you, boy. They see a white face. They can't shoot whitey like that. Y'all seen that other one that had that police was running backward. The Joker had a gun but charging him. Y'all ever seen it? Shit. I know that Joker track star. I'm talking about his ass will roll. Dude will cut. Listen, dude was charging his ass. Shoot me, shoot me. He said, I don't want to do it. Get me. Listen, I'm talking about roller. You see a body cam? I thought he was running this way. This Joker running back. He finally fell and hit the ground. Still, listen, gun still didn't go off. On the ground, he done fell back. Rock, wind shooter. The guy who charged him had already killed three people. This wasn't something he found out after when shooting. Oh, they had him on TV. He was a Marine, had been in combat. I'm trying to figure how somebody been in combat able to restrain themselves like this. When I'm coming, you've already killed three people. You're charging me now, and you're telling me to shoot you. I'm like, shit, listen, I appreciate this one. I tell you, I have a beer pulled out. This is for my homies. I'd have pulled it out on his ass right here. He asked for this one. He already done killed three people, and you charging me, and you tell me to kill you? I'm like, thank you. I don't know how I got this Baraka. I so appreciate it. This your ass. But just short, I want to tell you, this is the restraint they have. They claim they'll have the everything up. Oh, my training. See, did you flinch or something? My training. And that way I'm trained, most of y'all guys haven't been trained where I've been trained. See, in real life, when he went, all of my training kicked in, and before I knew, I shot him. And see, you can't judge whether or not he a threat, he have a weapon. All I know is the way I'm trained to defend, and they asked me clapping and praying for me. They can do whatever they want to do.
Yeah. Right.
Them the lie they done told us. And so many white folk, they want their shoot, getting them folk in their face, no gun, punking ass, hitting them with shit, dragging them, throwing it. Why I ain't scared these folks are gonna shoot me? Why do I have the security I'm not getting shot? Don't you need to ask yourself. Why do I not think I'm going to get shot? I'm charging people with guns because somebody already told me their orders were to stand down and not to shoot. There's no way in the world. How many niggas in protest with us, we just start running, charging the police? Why not? We know we get shot. What did that tell you to them white folk? Somebody told those, y'all are watching. I don't have to, I ain't no fool. Somebody told them, they were ordered, do not shoot. I guarantee you they were ordered, do not shoot. They want them to take their ass whipping. Now them folk mentally messed up. You see, some of them ain't shaved them white, saying why he ain't shaved sin. They had messed up. They say, look at, y'all set me up to kill me.
Yep.
And then they look at running their mouth, their ass going to jail.
Yep.
All you got to get them with certain stuff, they're going to tell you, you can't talk about it, still an investigation.
Yep.
They know how the system work. Them folks will kill your ass.
Yep.
Let me tell you something. It's a whole nother world operating. We don't even know nothing about. Whole nother world, these people. Everybody want to run, get in their world. You got to sell your soul out of these people a lot of time. You can't have no integrity, and they show you right there, they'll sacrifice. Just like these soldiers. The average soldier go there, I was going in there, and I was going in here to fight. No, hell, I went. I was going to get me, I would have been like, Kosh, I was going to get me a Chinese woman. I was going to get me one, I was. I damn sure was. I heard they do your toes and shit, and they don't be talking. I said, I'm going to get me one. All I wanted from Uncle Sam, he did, I'd been over there right now. I probably wouldn't have done shit, but I'd been there right now if I'd have got that hamburger that day. All I asked the man to do, when he couldn't produce that hamburger at the end of the day, I got through that physical. I told him, don't do it. They brought me in that room. They said, hey, they said, everything ran over. They said, we got to sign the contract. I said, contract? I said, I ain't eight. They said, listen. They said, everything ran over. They said, we got to go in here and get the contract. I did not walk in that room. All they had was sitting there, they said, recruit, sign. I said, sign a contract? I ain't even eight. I said, don't sign that. I said, don't sign that. They didn't even feed her. I see folks looking around like that. They said, hey, they said, I said, don't do it. They didn't even feed us. That man got me. That man said, he said, you finna have to go. You can't do that. I was like, what? I said, what? He said, you finna, I said, man, ain't going nowhere. I said, you gonna get me back like you brought me here? Shit, I wasn't no punk. That thing, I know my ass was on a motor bus. You know what, though? You know what I said? They ain't take my cornbread. That damn MP popped up on her ass. I said, they gave that nice, pretty little that little token. Your ass got, I was pissed. I had a car, I had to get on the bus. Oh, mad as hell. That hamburger, I ain't gonna lie. That thing was that big. Crinkle French fries. And they had a Coca-Cola, and the cup was sweating, and the bubbles were shooting out. Can y'all see this? Listen, the sandwich with it, I said, oh, hell, I'm killing it. Listen, soon they get me here, I'm just spraying folks' ass. If they the fed, I still be shooting. They're like, it's over. I tell them, sir, it ain't never over. That hamburger was that big, a large Coke. I'm talking about this, the way they stacked them fried cars, I looked them quick. I said, I'm my favorite fries. I like a loaded country. God bless them. I'm not gonna do it. That thing, though, they walked their ass out even. I swear, I'm trying to tell them, don't do it. They didn't feed us, don't sign nothing. I knew then, you's a liar. Crew done got out telling them lies. He said, yeah, he said, I said, what it be? He said, He said, you like lobster? I said, yeah. He said, shrimp and steak? I said, I had never ate no lobster. I'm like, well, hell, I gotta like it. I'm like, because I ain't had it. It gotta be good. But I had, you know, some little popcorn shrimp. Steak? Oh, hell yeah. Even though I ate cube steak, I want the real. Y'all were cheap. Y'all play hell out of me, Ma. I tell you. There I was all my life thinking I'm eating steak. We mean cube steak. Where the little checkers in, like somebody done sold the damn meat together. Oh, you feel bad, huh? My brother got my hand on steak and told me, what is this? How many of y'all ate cube steak? I didn't know no better. You thinking you on the rich end, you, it's a steak. Is there another one outside of this one? I had the chop steak where you take the hamburger and put the gravy on it. I knew the what, but they said that's a steak. It's chopped. That's what it is. Boy, they so play. How many of y'all had T-bone steak when y'all were little? You had when you were little? 10, yeah, I am. Hold on, he gonna run. What am I saying? Rudy, how old were you when you had a T-bone steak? How old? 12. Man, the same, Yahushua, he was 12 when he went in the temple, the teeth. Y'all should barbecue every day. Every day. Rudy, that's impossible. What year you were born? I'm saying, what year you grew up in? What years? In the 80s or 70s? Then when you were born? When you were born? In the 80s, right? 78. No, you ain't no state. You ain't no state. But 78, that'll put you around 84, 80, no, 90. Hell, 78, 88, you've been 10. So like 2000, I mean 1990? Yeah, think about it. Yeah. I don't think quite. We haven't been liberated like that. Chris, well, how old were you eating a T-bone steak? You know Rudy. Both of y'all born in 78. Did you know? Oh my goodness. He said mom was preparing and went to eat at the White House. Is that the house that wasn't painted black? Well, that's all right now. Y'all, like, yeah, that's right. We keep a finding. I don't know about that one. How many rest of y'all were eating T-bone steak when y'all? Kerry, hold on for a minute. Kerry, didn't you grow up in the woods of Atlanta?
My best friend, mama, man. She was
your best friend, mama. She had T-bone steak? She was different. Real different. What about your aunt, Yvonne? I thought she was laughing at you. Okay, forget her. But your best friend had you.
This lady was different.
She was different.
She was a fantastic cook.
Fantastic cook. Cooking. You would be a fantastic cook and never cook a T-bone steak now.
She gave me my first T-bone steak.
What'd you think about that, kid?
I don't know.
You don't know about it. How old were you when you ate your first one?
When I was
That's what I'm talking about. I'm thinking the same thing with Kerry. Kerry, you grew up in Atlanta. You're a Grady baby.
What conversation we just had?
He's talking about he go to conversation they just had. What conversation y'all just had so we can know?
Just talking about Aunt Mary.
Talking about Aunt, Aunt Mary. All we know about Aunt Yvonne. How many of you ever heard about Kerry or Aunt Mary? How much I never heard nobody Aunt Mary? Kerry, you can't make up these aunts as you going. When we get y'all in, we ask y'all to confess your poor name, everybody in your family.
You know all the kids that grow up together, man, we all
cousins. All y'all cousins, everybody grow up, that's true.
Everybody auntie.
Everybody auntie. That's true. I can't argue with that. He told the truth for that. That's the truth for them. But we ain't never heard about no aunt. If I had an Aunt Mary bought me steak, I'd talk about it all the time. It'd be Yahuwah, Yahushua, Aunt Mary. I got to keep it like that. You feed me steaks at a young age? How old you were, Damon, first time you ate a steak? I'm about with you right now. There's a lot going on. Who was that, Damon? Oh, hold on. You ate a steak? How old were you when you ate a steak? 10. What year was this? 98. 96. Quit, what's wrong with that year? In 98, I had been married for 3 years. Goodness, but had a steak. Was it a T-bone steak or a chop steak? Oh, hell, you went way too high now. That's way too expensive. I know, hey, how old you were? 50 what? First time you had a steak. Yeah, well, hey, I know when you ate bologna. But you ate bologna right, that was a poor man's steak. You put enough mayonnaise on that thing, you could damn near bury the meat. You put enough mayonnaise in there, it'll come up like super glue. You try to lift the bread up to look at it. Y'all see it. It's like, you know them people how they seal and they have them little drops up there. You ever see folks put that money when you lift the bread up? I hate mayonnaise. Except in potato salad, you make it real, real yellow. I know there's a lot of y'all mayonnaise people around here. I'm trying to get y'all. You a mayonnaise person? Rudy got a question. What is it, Rudy?
Oh, no. Oh,
Miracle Whip. I ain't never getting nothing out of it. That's why I ain't do Miracle Whip. I wasn't impressed with it. I did mayonnaise, and that was it. I didn't want them. I grew up in the country. You eat so many damn mayonnaise sandwiches. That's why I hate it. I ate too many. I used to love mayonnaise. I got so many. You just get it and mash the bread and just ask to be eating. Why show you my eat? I hate it with all my heart. That's why I hate it. If you grow up eating it, how many of y'all had to eat mayonnaise sandwiches growing up? Man, shit, let me tell you something. That was a lunch, like that lunch. That folks said, don't fuck waste no meat for your ass in the country. You got a little cheap ass hot dog that wouldn't swell up? Mayonnaise sandwiches. That's your lunch. Run on lunch, that's your lunch. Y'all kids, man, y'all got, man, y'all grew up in a whole nother, you talking about sugar sandwiches. Take sugar, sub sandwich. Man, you take that syrup and put that thing and mash that thing down. You ain't syrup sandwiches. Straight heart attack. The syrup sandwich wasn't that bad, damn thing leaked through. You been mash it down and try to make it hold together. Try to kill that strong bread. That bread be thick. You need something to wash down. Like a peanut butter jelly sandwich, a peanut butter sandwich, that thing will damn near kill you. Boy, if you ain't got no saliva in your mouth, I'm telling you, they don't want to show the statistic because people won't eat it. There's a lot of folks that die from peanut butter sandwiches. Man, you get the jet chewing in, you be good before you go. That's it, hit back. But you got to run and get you something quick to get that thing out. I'm telling you, you can kill a nigga with them peanut butter sandwiches. Yeah, I ain't big on them anymore. They ain't have no gel on it. Then they came out with the peanut butter jelly mint in the 70s. It was nasty, but hell, it was exciting. All I do is look at the jar, try to figure how the hell they get both of these in the same jar. Ain't that right? We would have to mix it. Well, I'm telling you, mess up, and I can tell you, don't lie. How many of y'all want to be saved? Hold, put your hand out. We talking about say. Put your hand back up. So say. All right, how many of y'all asked to do this? I know your ass. Put that knife in the peanut butter and stick in the damn jelly. Where your ass at? Repent. I'm sorry for my wrong. Man, that you see that thing transfer over in there? You're like, oh. Look out, you did it too. Thank you, she better now. So I'm gonna take the knife, put the peanut butter and put it over the jelly. Oh, you can't do that. Then get the knife. Where you at? Don't lie. Where you at? Want to make it in? I ain't sure. I might have done it before. Boy, them were some times, ain't it? Man, we come from some poor times. You look at it now. But you know what? You were happy you had that little stuff. Then, man, you want you a good little drink. Go in that refrigerator, to get that cup and screw the bum in. Get you that ice and fill it. You get that cup, just start scrubbing up through that.
Don't be scrubbing my damn refrigerator.
Yeah, cut yourself a cup balls up in the top. Man, we drunk so much damn Freon, we had no idea. That's why a lot of y'all around here, how many of y'all used to do that? Scrub and get the ice. That's why your ass be cold around here. That is. Man, he's sober. Cam, y'all used to do it up there in Chicago. Screw up the top of the refrigerator with the cup. Did y'all done had the ice? Now y'all sign. Y'all must have had the frost-free refrigerator. That was the worst refrigerator in the world. You want fun. You need that scrub at the top. And them old metal ice tray. You get that water, put it. Them metal, we ain't had a plastic. We had the metal, the whole one. Them damn things be inside the water moving. And you know, you kept it away. You got to set it down. We had the metal one. Them things worth money. Now you can save them now. Damn, we throw them away for them plastic ones. Get them plastic. You can put your they show them on TV. You get the little, the little popsicle thing and stick them in there. We ain't had time no shit like that. Two pit now. We Henry Gray not finished. He damn sure ain't gonna buy no popsicle stick. We putting it down refrigerator stick in no ice tray. That one happened. That was stuff you watched on TV. White kids do that. How many of y'all used to do that? Y'all must stay around some white people. No, they ain't play all that stuff. This is something to go back our life. Y'all kids didn't get hell nothing from. We're gonna let y'all, we know what we're gonna do. We're gonna bring some sub and let y'all make sub sandwiches. You're welcome, Najee. Mayonnaise sandwich. How many of y'all want mayonnaise? How about a mustard sandwich? Yeah. Let y'all make a mustard sandwich with salt and pep on it. That way when y'all get, like Courtney, when you get grown, when you get 12, you can tell the other kids about it. Say, back when I was a kid, I used to make these sandwiches, but now I'm grown. So we try to get that set up for y'all. They're going to help out. Dan, you want to try one? Which one? Mayonnaise sandwich or sub sandwich? All right, mayonnaise sandwich, a salt and pepper, and mustard sandwich. So you think about it. That thing sound good, don't it? Salt and pepper and mayonnaise. I mean, and mustard. You know what I like? You think about that, ain't it? I might get that and sell it on the market. All I had to do is get Shemir on the fry for me. Ain't that right? Oh, that'd be different. We get it. We make it. Drop it in some grease and fry it like a grilled cheese and bring it out. Let me tell you something. These folks out here greedy as hell. They get that thing. They be so excited. Woo, they do. Well, I've been waiting on. I've been praying on this. I've been praying on some mustard. Now, how many of y'all ate ketchup sandwich? I might have ate one. Let me tell you, you're a kid and you hungry as hell, man. You got to wait. It's like your mom don't get home to way late to cook. You gotta start finding stuff around how you can eat, ain't that right? You gotta find stuff that's gonna hold you over. How many of y'all eat Vienna sausage?
Yes.
With them crackers?
Yes.
Boy, you pop that can and pour that juice off. Pour them Vienna. Them sardines? You gotta have them crackers with them sardines. If you got them saltine, listen, saltine make it all right. God damn it. You don't like sardines? Y'all don't like sardines? Sardine? Who?
In oil or water?
Which one?
In sardine, they come in oil or water.
Mine had oil. Ain't nobody coming to water. They must have did that later. Sardine and water. Ain't no hell that mine came in at all. Man, you pop that top and pour that juice. Man, look at him. You pull them sardines out, you got to get them out there without breaking them up. God almighty, no. Listen, yuck, got the little bone in it. All that edible. Sandy, y'all done eat none in Mexico? Sardines, y'all done have none? She had some. And you came from your mama. That means you ate some. You got breastfed. The milk in the bottle had a little bit in it. She didn't tell you about it. Then you eat sardines. Y'all done made it before in kit. Got sardine right now. That's sardine. That's real stuff. Damn, you ain't like sardine? That was seared meat. I couldn't. I'm telling you what nasty. Pot meat. Oh, my shit. You like some baby shit in the can. I said, no. That ain't nothing but that. That but I said, no. Pot meat. I didn't like that. That mashed up. I didn't like it. I said, what did they done pot? I said, I can't eat this stuff. Sow's meat. Got all that pep in it. Yeah, they should get her. She feeling guilty. They brought her home. Man, they buy by the pack. My dad go to he go to Farmer Mark and tell man, cut me off some. And you're like, what are we gonna do? Throw in the trash? Mayonnaise up that bread and put it in there. You gotta eat this, son. He the word for it, but that man throw his stuff, throw that shit in there, and throw an egg in his stuff and screw her. Hula! I said, not that again. Corned beef is good. Sometimes just too oily. Some folks could just grease it. Now, y'all ate that corned beef? We need to get, you know what we need to do? We're going to get a store. We're going to cook some old time stuff. We at the end of that, these kids, and y'all need to eat stuff. Like, we're going to get y'all big and strong. Then let y'all eat them big old yellow Cheetos, the big, none of that, them puffs. Damn hand be so orange. You like a damn little tiger. Ain't that right? Them things, that color, come on your head. Listen, you gotta suck your finger, Jay. You be licking that. Man, I don't know what, listen, ain't gonna tell what inside our guts look like. You can't get them off your hand, cause all that sucking and going down. Them hands still be yelling. You be just a happy. Hot fries. Them used to be some, well, hot fries. I thought them were french fries one time. Them things were so good. Y'all kids eat hot fries? Lemon head? They'll eat lemon head? Boston baked beans. Yes, Boston baked beans, Sarah. Now, y'all didn't know nothing about no squirrel nuts. Uncle Ted picked me up a song. They run. Them squirrel nuts, y'all need to try them. Listen, them thing good. Oh, my goodness. They got little tiny nuts in them. Them thing with the caramel. Y'all ain't had them squirrel nuts? Oh, my goodness. I don't know. Some of the candy they got real need to be back on the shelf. Yeah. Now they had another one with good, Zero. Ew. That white chat, that white, y'all remember Zero? It was on a blue pack, it was white. Old Henry bar. That $100,000 bar went bad. 100 grand? I know what is 100 grand? Yeah, 100 grand. Yeah, 100, yeah, that thing that was serious. We need to go pick up something. I know a place in Atlanta. If they still open, they ain't died. Over there by Boulevard. No, they got all them old candies. Right down there where Ivan Allen at. You remember, it's a store down there. It's still there, you know what I'm talking about, that store? Listen, they got all the old candy, all the old cookies. They had them old cookies. I forgot the one, it had the yellow, it had a pink on there. What it called? The plank, yeah, they got all that. They got all that stuff. It'll have that pink coating across the top of it, then it had a yellow one. Yeah. But I'm serious. I'm serious. They got all that. Listen, that place need to be guarded. They need to guard that thing like at the White House. You ain't that? That's some good eating. I can't remember the cookie. It was called the planks. It's a cookie about like that. It's two of them in there. It'll have a yellow coating on across one of them, and then it'll have a pink one. But that pink was slamming. That was some good stuff. We got to get y'all back to the old time way. We're going to try to get ready to move on now because Mike about to lose it back now. Mike, what was your favorite candy? He can't figure. He's still eating them. What was your favorite candy? Caramel. There ain't no candy. That's not like an official candy. Hey, man, how the, you know what, though? Now, they did have a little caramel candy. It was that cute, and it had something in the middle. It had some, had some little white or something in the middle. That little rolled up one. Yeah, I'm serious. What was the name? Y'all remember it came a little, it was a clip. It was raw. I don't remember the name of it, but you remember it was caramel. It had something little white in the middle of it. Yep, clear packet. It was a. Then you had the cube too, and they had one of them rolled, and they had the little white in there. Boy, that was serious back there. That wasn't no Halloween candy. You think about the black and the yellow one. You think about the black and the orange when they had rubber. That Halloween candy. That man way out there. That man ain't hot. You can't eat that one filthy. You gave that to kids you hate. That's the worst candy in the world. Man, folks see that old tired ass can of black. You see that stuff, man? Don't put that shit in my bag, man. Man, where you get that old ass candy? Y'all remember that Halloween candy? It'd be orange and be in the black paper. The paper looked scary. I hated it. They need to pass out these damn folks to quit playing and go home then. Y'all kids ever had some of that Halloween candy? They don't know they called it. It was, then they had it in the little pumpkin head. I never liked that shit. Maybe we'll find y'all some so y'all will grow up to hate it too. All right, we're going to get it moved forward. Y'all done enough damage now. That candy stuff got me going. I got to go find that place. You said they still over there?
It's on Boulevard.
It's right off Boulevard. Right down from Georgia Baptist. You know what's that, Uncle Ted? You know what Boulevard at, don't you? All right, you know at the red light right there at the corner where the hospital at. And you make a, if you coming off of 75, you make a left off that Jimmy car, make a left on Boulevard, going down. And it, yep, it's on the right hand, you make a right, right there, that light, where the hospital, where the end, right there for the end. That's a gas station on the other end, you make a right, go down that street. And Allen Ivan Allen, the furniture place right there by him. They got all the old candy, all that old candy you look for, they sell all of it. Y'all ain't supposed to know that stuff. I also used to be the candy lady before. I done some of everything. So I was the candy man. I'll stick one of them kids. All right, we'll get right to the cartos around. It's that candy broke Malcolm down. I'll be new, our Father. I do again, thanks for allowing us to be here, for all that you granted and given us and an opportunity to be able to yakra upon your shim, which is call upon your name. We seek you for redemption from our kata'im, which are our sins, our ma'al, which are our transgressions, blotting it out according to the berith you shabbat to Abraham, Yitzchak, Jacob, the Yahudim and Yasharal to their Tuladoth, which are their generations, even to us and our Tuladoth, to establish us in the Amoth, which is the truth. Search us and see if there be any Rosh Hadarach, which are any evil ways. Cast it from us and lead us into Arach, everlasting, which is the way of life. Let the debar of our path, which are the words of our mouth, let the meditation of our laws, which is of our hearts, be acceptable in your own. Barak of those that watching in, those that ask us palau form and with them that seek you and your understanding. Baraka us, which will bestow a gift or a benefit upon us, to limit us and seal us with the Ruach HaKadosh. Baraka the out of towns and strengthen them that they don't falter and they don't faint. Be their Nakum, which is their consolation. Hadu for what you've done thus far for Akuf Nikki and being a strength and understanding to Chris. Continue to be a healer and restorer. Be with us all and forgive us for all we've thought and done and perpetrated and acted upon that were contrary to your Kudash will. Hadu for granting us an understanding, for being patient with us, for allowing us an opportunity to seek your Yeshua, which is your salvation. Baraka your Shalakim, which are your sent ones, your Ra'ah, your shepherds, and your Malaki, which are your Malaki, which are your messengers, your Shamaim, your Sabut, which are the heights expansion where you dwell in your armies. Baraka Jerusalem, the city of Shalom, which is a peace. As we prepare to move further, we palau in which we ask that you take full control. That you get the Tahalim, the praise, the Kabut, the glory, and the Kabod, the honor, and the Shem, which is the name of Yahushua, HaMashiach. Let us all say, Amen. I guess I want to, as I'm getting started, kind of get everybody to kind of understand my situation for, you know, my using and my expression of anger about situations and my usage of words I use is because I'm pissed. I'm really tired of our situation. You know, years ago I wasn't conscious of it because, you know, you just start to accept things as they say. You know, that's just how the things are. That's just the way the world is, and that's how things are. But that's no excuse for the atrocity that's been committed against us and the fact that we've had to bite our tongue, our lips, and our tonsils. We've had to restrain ourselves on so many levels, and we were forced to not even hate them. I mean, it's one thing you silence me, it's another thing you only let me have a control of my own feelings. I can't hate you, I can't fight you, I can't say anything negative about you, I still gotta love you, I still gotta treat you right, and I gotta pray for you. It's shit mind-boggling. How does the person that takes the captive who was free, and then controls their emotions? The shit mind-boggling. It's scary, the fact that we've been here so long, they induced us with some type of metaphor or something, that we actually think that we're gonna burn in hell if we hate people that do us wrong. That's crazy. If I do something to you who was the initiator, I'm worse than the person that started it. How did you get me to buy into that? Y'all know I'm telling the truth. That's no excuse. They hit you, you shouldn't hit them. Y'all remember in school, two kids get to fight, and Freddie wasn't up, who hit who first? Yep. That's who we're going to suspend. Now, both of y'all got to get suspended. Yep. And we might think it's nothing, but look how it works on us when it comes to them. Right. So we look at, rather than fight back, I'd rather just hold the peace and let the Lord fight my battle. The Lord not going to fight for us. That's their God. We serve Elohim. Elohim came to give us an understanding. And the fact that everything that they perpetrated on us, there's never even been an apology. Even when it come down to us, the book teaches that if my ox offend me, he's supposed to say, forgive me. He's supposed to say, forgive me. He said, if he do it 70 times in a day and say, forgive me. He said, you're supposed to do it. And you know what the Charlotte King, the potter said? You're going to increase my armor now. That's going to be, they look, that you, because I can't see no person doing that to me. I can't see nobody doing no shit like that for no 400 some years. There's not even a question about our armor now. It's the question of who told, whose soul it be. And then when he told me to do it, that was my Aki. My Akuth. You're not my art. Why in the hell am I forgiving you for it?
That's right.
See, they took your book, things that were principle on how we were supposed, because everything was supposed to work there. If a situation broke out between them, the ball was supposed to bring us back together, because I was supposed to, if I was wrong, I was supposed to admit that I was wrong, and I was supposed to make restitution. That's going to fix it. I take something from you. He said, no, you can't give her back what you took. Give her more than that. You took it. You need to understand the expense of what you've done, and they need to know that they were that Elohim had come back. He had rewarded them for their loss. Think about it. You take something, he got to come back before 7-4-4. So you say, I take 100 off you, and I couldn't give you 400. You pissed about your, what you say about the 400? Damn that 400. You thinking, you know, okay, you know, and Yahuwah let you know, get what? Then nobody take nothing from you. I ain't make them come back and recompense you better than what they took. He look at you, shouldn't have took it. Man, come on, they ain't fair. Let me just give back what I took. No, you store that man more than what you took. You give that man back. That was the teacher, because you got to think, it's certain thing with hold, but when you look at somebody in a sense to us overcompensated, I can't hold that. I can't hold it. So he gave us tools to use among us to keep us in fellowship and what we talk about being in harmony. They try, how the hell you try to be in harmony with some people can't harmonize? Let's get on the same beat. Let's serve the same Elohim. Let's believe the same thing. We can't harmonize with these people. They don't even believe what we believe. And we'll put more effort in trying to show every white person we see, I'm not a racist. Should I really be explaining this? When I've taken what from white people? I invoke what inflict? I put what laws on white people? What restraint? What the hell are we trying to prove we ain't racist for? So you living, ain't you? More than what you would let me do. First opportunity chance, a couple of them getting, they can get away with it. I ask snatch. They don't let that, and what bad, the people that hate us, ain't even people had a reaction with us. It ain't. I personally did something to them personally, or personally me, I did something to somebody that's living their family. It's some shit down heard from way back they're going to recite that they don't know what the hell they even talking about. Why you hate? Because you're a nigger. Oh, what's the mean? You nigger? What's the mean? You nigger, the meaning is nigger. I thought you don't know the hell you talking about. You don't know the hell you talking about. You don't even know what you're talking about. You just playing word circles. A nigga, what's a nigga? Your mama. Okay. You still don't know the answer. You know what I'm saying? The fact that we give credence to these people, we give time to these people. Isn't that right? But there's some other people that let these people do what they do. These are people that are more dangerous. There are people that want these people on the street because they keep a divide among us. See, why these ignorant backwood bastards are fighting and arguing with us, some people that look like them are the people making laws. That's invoking things to keep both our ass under and behind the eight ball. Y'all know that? That's the truth. A lot of people say I'm just telling the truth. But see, we can't talk truth with every nationality. Everybody want to talk the truth. Nobody, all these nationalities not going to give them admit what they done us. We'll run to them and try to be like them. They don't want us. Don't fool yourself. They don't want us. Don't believe. They don't want us. There are people in the group that look at, ain't fair what's happening to us. The groups as a whole, they don't accept you. You tell them lie to somebody else. That don't work. Ain't no these folks put that shot they want. You go to set aside, you can go to hell. Right. None of them folks don't care about us. Yeah. Don't believe it. Nope. It's in pop. They don't, as a whole group, no, hell no. No. All people look at when you come somewhere, the same way we came out of Mizraim, you're going to lap up everything. You're going to take up everything. You're going to black everything. You're a showboat. Man, white folk had the best little basketball. Hey, he didn't get sweated. Nigga take the shit. He got to take the ball and brought that shit back here. Put you like, where the hell the ball went? Got to let that shit roll down their arm and come out. They're like, this shit ain't it. What is that? It put me on the ground. Oh, I'm going to put it back down now. White folk run. Hey, listen. You cannot do no little better than a white man. That's the move. Nigga, look at that shit. He said, man, I gotta do something different. Yeah. Man, you seen folk do shit getting the air, man. Y'all seen that? Somebody said that Instagram. That Joker jumped up in the air. Y'all saw that? Listen, the ball was stuck in the rim. Y'all saw that? Oh, shit. Listen, dude ran, jumped in the air, kicked the ball. It was stuck up there in the rim when he kicked the ball in. Another dude came, caught it, and yoked that shit. You! Damn, nigga, this ain't any, what you doing? Right. But white people said, first of all, take the ball, and he kicked the ball. Yeah. What are you looking at? Damn that finesse. Yeah. Anything you give her, we gonna add something else to it now. It's innate, it's just some shit we gonna do. It's like, it's too boring anyway. We gotta see if we can do something else with it. It's always some issue we gonna do with it. I know, and it bothers people. Like, he ain't supposed to be. We sung that. Marvin Gaye sung the national anthem. He sung his ass off. Now, I'm going to tell you who butchered that damn thing now. Carl Lewis. I can't got that mic, so give me that mic. Hell no. I don't even sing the song, but damn, you ain't finna sing here and sing it like that. Now. And we not having that. I told you, we not having that in here. How many of y'all ever heard Carl Lewis sing the national anthem? How many of y'all hadn't heard him? Boston. And what we're going to do, and on all white people, listen, this is the only time I'm allowed. I want all y'all to stand, please. And Carl, make your ass out. Y'all stand. Carl, y'all listen, Carl. Huh, we're waving to get ready. Y'all give a hold. Y'all wait. Give it. So white folk can feel better.
I guess that's it then, huh?
Get you some insurance later.
Dirty Harry said in one of his movies that a man's got to know his limitations. Carl Lewis apparently didn't see the movie. If his rendition of the Star Spangled Banner prior to the Nets Bulls game last night is any indication, as a public service, we present now only excerpts. Ladies and gentlemen, our national anthem.
All right, are we all ready? Oh!
That was so much better.
If white folk wants to stand up for it, tell them let Carl Lewis sing. He damn near got a TMI. They got one a little longer. Let them just, let them, y'all ain't got to stop y'all just him. Then Carl put his heart out there for him. We'll just let y'all hear a little bit of him.
Are we ready? It's always good to be back in Jersey. How about some next? Wait a minute, I'm hearing the booze here. All right, are we all ready?
Yeah, we ready, Carl.
Here we go. Say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the rampart we watched with so gallantly streaming, and the rockets red flag. The bombs bursting in gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. I'll make up for it now. We'll say, does that star-spangled banner get way o'er the land?
Brought Carl Lewis that lost their job. But I appreciate Carl. Hell, for what they done did for, that's the best they'll damn get. Ain't nobody did no better. Considering how they done shit it up, that's the best way to sing it. They ain't had nobody sing that thing better than Carl Lewis. In that way, where we been shitting and beat it and bullshitted around him, Carl, you did a great job. Isn't that right? That's what they get, the kind of job done gave it. They deserve Carl. He need to sing it every damn time they get it. I go there just to stand up. Even the rest of them side tell them, stay y'all ass up. Much of these folks done died and fought for this country. That's what they ass get. Appreciate it. So now y'all got that in y'all repertoire. Sometimes you can't sleep at night, just put it on while you're beside your bed. All right, then Romans 15 and 4. Try to move forward. Y'all are off the chain right here. All right, y'all ready?
Yes, sir.
All right. Come along and ride on the... Huh? So y'all couldn't come out of it. Y'all couldn't get... Y'all just, I see where y'all at now. Me and Lee working on one for y'all, though. Y'all don't wait. I had Breezy and... Oh, Lee, y'all joking. Don't y'all want to see me get here and do one? Listen. These guys are sitting on my talent. I brought it to them. Did I bring a good one to them? I told them something. Huh? But I can't get no reciprocation. Just can't do what you want. First of all, we don't even dare like no Coke, no Sprite. You got the rhythm of Carl Lewis singing. That's the rhythm right there to go to his song. You know? But now I done gave him some stuff. I told him, I said, listen, we can work this one. We can put it out here, we can do it. And there's some stuff that y'all will be moving now. I made sure for a technique.
Yes.
It'd be to make you move. I guess that we'll guess anyone. We were talking about one other night when we leave. It'll work now. I'm telling y'all, it make you move too. Huh? You be like, it's Daoud dance out here close, so it's okay. Yeah. Ain't that right? So wear two pair of drawers. I guess they're gonna let me out one day. I've been like, y'all sitting on me cold, putting me in the game. All right, Romans 15:4, listen.
For whatever Nikatah before.
For whatever was written before.
Nikatah for our lament.
That's good to know. Uh-huh.
That we through endurance.
Somebody said quit. I heard that. Landing, got in the spirit too. Fast. Like, quit. No. That's right. They're going through without quitting.
And the coon.
That's right, a reward. That's right. What happened?
Of the Ketubim.
Uh-huh. All writings.
Might have tikva.
I know we read this every time again. Y'all know why we do it for our foundation.
That's right.
On a real note, it's always important to remind ourselves of why it's there. People can, you know, we all, how many people we know that gone through him that's gone, that's quit? And you know why? Because they didn't take this for face value. If you don't take this for faith, but why would he have to write something to keep you from quitting? Say what now? I can't hear you.
Because we're going.
I thought Ray said that. Ray moved his mouth. Y'all said the same thing? I know. What did y'all say the same thing? What did you say again, Kasha? You covered your mic. Exactly. I think what happens with us, we really don't take it for what he's telling us. It was so important to write this and to know that it was written so you don't quit. Y'all know that? We take it for granted that we're here. The bar is supposed to enrich us in a way that when things come again, he know in society things are going to come against you. You can tell yourself all you want, you're living right, that you're complying. These things out here gonna come against you. And when these things out here come against you, they'll make you quit. They will make you quit. And it's important to be able to go back and look at the debar and realize this is why I'm adhering, which is sticking or holding fast to something. Because you will actually quit. You will give up. People, you might think you're here on your own. You're not. And if you are, it's just a matter of time you're gonna fall away. You can't be here on your own. You can't. Something has to draw you. That's what he told us, that no ish can come unto me except the other which sent me. That's why I asked y'all before about the importance of how did you get here? How did you come? How did you come? How did you get here? Y'all understand that? I'm going to say. See if that's the third chapter of the book of Allah Shemut. Ooh, they call Exodus, ooh, all are. I know y'all don't really think nothing about it, but you should. The fact that, you know, he allow us to have some leeway, what we'll call to be in control, and then he allow you to get out of control. I'm talking about out of you being able to, like you saying, I'm used to being a person where I can keep things a certain way. I'm a person keep things in a certain order. I'm a person like a thing a certain way. I've always had that way. He unravels that about us. That's the only way he get us him. There's a lot of things I've liked, I've done, I had a certain. He unraveled that to show me you can't. It's not gonna work. Not unless I have to exist inside of it. The existing one has to exist inside of what we do, of what we do. Y'all know that? Okay. I mean, you think about this. I tell you what. Let's look at it. How about that? Let's see what happened. Listen.
Now, Musha kept the flock of Jethro, his Abba-in-law, the Kohen of Midian, and he led the flock to the backside of the desert and came to the heart of Elohim, even to Horeb.
Uh-huh.
And the Malachi of Yahuwah appeared unto him in a flame of fire out of the midst of a bush. And he looked, and behold, the bush burned with fire, and the bush was not consumed.
Mm-hmm.
And Musha said, I will now turn aside and see this great Un, why the bush is not burnt.
Mm-hmm. So what was he going to do? He used Un. Can I see hands? Hands? He used Un. What? He was just going to see? That's right. And seeing, he was going to see what, look back to 2. And the Malachi of Elohim appeared to him in a flaming fire out of the bush. And he sees, because we look at his sight, eyes, that the bush burns with fire, but the bush was not consumed. And Musha said, I will go near and see this great sight, why the bush is not consumed. So he wanted to go and get the knowledge of. That's right, the appearance, we talked about the knowledge. He wanted the information. That's what knowledge is. It's a range of information. Y'all remember that from my young people? Knowledge is a range of information. Y'all got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So he wanted to go and get the information concerning it, okay? And let's see what happened.
And when Yahuwah saw that he turned aside to Elohim Yakra unto him out of the midst of the bush and said, Musha, Musha. And he said, here am I.
Mm-hmm. Let's see.
And he said, draw not nigh hither.
Draw where?
Not nigh hither.
Come and told him to
put off thy shoes from off thy regal.
Yes.
For the Malkum whereon thou standest is Kudash Adumah.
That's right. And what happened?
Moreover, he said, I am the Elohim of thy Abba, the Elohim of Abraham, the Elohim of Yasakat, and the Elohim of Yaakov. And Musha hid his pani, for he was afraid to look upon Elohim.
Uh-huh.
And Yahuwah said, I have surely seen the affliction of my own, which are in Mizraim, and have shama their sa'ak by reason of their taskmasters, for I know their sorrows.
Mm-hmm.
And I am come down to deliver them out of the hand of the Mizraim, and to bring them up out of that arats unto a tube arats and
hold,
a large.
Hold what you got for a second. Look at the 53rd chapter on the book of Yeshayahu. We'll read down. Okay? Listen. They call it Isaiah 53:1. Listen what it asks.
Who hath Ammon our report?
Let me ask y'all a question. That's what you want to ask yourself right here. Who believed it? Elohim has sent somebody down and told you that I am acquainted with your afflictions. Who believed it?
Right.
When was Elohim beaten? When was Elohim under the scrutiny and strictness of? Yeshayahu just asked y'all who has believed our report.
That's right.
You just tell me that you were acquainted with my afflictions. Who believed it? That's who they told us.
And to whom is the arm of Yahuwah revealed?
Go ahead.
For he shall grow up before him as a tender plant.
Yes.
And as a root out of the dry arats, he hath no form nor comeliness. And when we shall see him, there is no beauty that we should desire him.
Mm-hmm.
He is despised and forsaken of Anashim, a ish of sorrows and acquainted with grief.
Mm. And that's what Yahuwah told you. That he was acquainted with it. He knew your sorrow. So what was he doing? Hands. Tell him, Dexter. He took knowledge of. Next answer, Austin. He was declaring the end at the beginning. First thing you should think about is somebody telling you something. How believable is it for you? Elohim hadn't been under the rulership of nobody. Elohim hadn't been beaten. Elohim hadn't been stricken. Elohim wasn't nobody. Remember, that his form, it was going to be that we wouldn't even desire it.
That's right.
But let's see something. At the third chapter, book of Bereshit. 3 and 1, they call Genesis. Listen.
Now the Nakash was more subtle than any beast of the field which Yahuwah Elohim had made. And he said unto the Ashar, yea, hath Elohim said, ye shall not eat of every ox of the gun.
Listen.
And the Ashar said unto the Nakash, we may eat of the pari of the ox of the gun, but of the pari of the ox which is in the midst of the gun, Elohim has said, ye shall not eat of it, neither.
Oh, three, they move up. Go ahead.
Elohim has said, ye shall not eat of it, neither shall you touch it, lest ye move.
Mm-hmm.
And the Nakar said unto the Ashar, ye shall not surely move.
Tell them what happened.
For Elohim doth know.
You said Elohim did what? He don't?
Doth know.
What?
That in the yom ye eat thereof, then your own shall be open, and ye shall be as mighty ones, knowing Tub and Roshan.
And let's see. Because his appearance and all was so very good, so veered that we wouldn't even desire it. And what happened?
And when the Ashar saw that the ox was Tub for food, and that it was pleasant to the Un, and a ox to be desired to make one wise, she took of the pari thereof and did eat, and gave also unto her husband with her, and he did eat.
So what was her desire? To be like Elohim. Mm. So now he came along and now he just told us that he was acquainted with our sorrows. So when we actually heard that, I mean, the difference of us with us and the people of before, they were people of things had to be plainly understood. We moved by the spirit. You know, the spirit, it's a lot of stuff you don't understand. You just have to go, don't make sense. It's gotta make sense. You said you was acquainted with it. You were accustomed and you said it, although it happened to you. You were familiar with it. But when we understand what he told you, I want you to, you have to always be thinking that he was declaring the end at the beginning. He had to come back. Yes, Yahoo asked you, who had among our report? Who believed it? That Elohim were under and somebody being and he was subject to? Wow. Wow. It's hard for me to believe. Until. That's the purpose of Yes, Yahoo coming and letting him know. He had to stay for him to let him know. Who has among our report? And to whom is the arm of Yahuwah been revealed? We heard about his arm, which was his strength. And we hadn't really, we seen some things. He won't know. He said, well, I'm going to do something. In that 52nd verse, 57th chapter, 52nd chapter just above it, and about verse 12 or 13, he said, well, I'm going to make bare the arm.
That's right.
Because he asked, to whom has it been revealed? Well, if I made it bare. So we had to see him stripped. That this was the arm of Elohim. And now we heard what Yeshayahu said, it made sense to us. Hello? Nobody wanted to go through that. Not me. In it? But this man was acquainted with our griefs and our sorrow. Y'all got it? And then we understood that the chastisement of our shalom was upon him. You know, Christian, how many of y'all heard Christian church saying, I wish they would have done that to my Lord or something that they shouldn't have beat my Lord. You see how dumb they are? Because yeah. Let me see what Yeshua Yahu 53. See, in their mind, they think they got a spiritual attribute, they got some knowledge. You have no knowledge. Because you're talking about pure ignorance. It went any other way, you couldn't even be ransomed. You couldn't even be redeemed if it went any other way. Let's see what he told 53, where we left off, 53 and 4.
Verse 3.
3? All right, listen.
He is despised and forsaken of Anashim, a Ish of sorrows.
Hold on. It's 3? Okay, despised, but his form was okay. Ignoble and inferior to that of the Benim of Anashim. See, this read different. A man of sorrows and acquainted with grief. a man is suffering and acquainted with the bearing of sickness, affliction. Y'all got it? Oh, you think about it. When he withdrew from them, the book said that his sweat was as what?
Drops of blood.
You find a person sweating profusely, sometimes it's a fever. Man, he was sweating so hard, they said it fell. It was like drops of blood, a dom. This man was he was acquainted with, he suffered with. Hello? Okay. Let's see. You don't know it, but kataim is a sickness.
Yeah.
Sin is a sickness.
That's right.
And here a man was had to bear ours. So he was acquainted with our affliction. Why do you think these diseases come on and these things happen? Hello? Let me see. See if that right. See if that's Allah Shemut 15. I think that's what I want. 15. I want to say 22. Ooh. It's called Exodus. Ooh Allah Shemut. Might be 17. I don't know why I'm thinking 22. No. So go up or down. Down, up. They should have talked about the sickness. They'll put none of them on them. They put on the Mizraim. So, what verse?
26.
Okay. Give me 25. It's been a while. I remember it been years. Now my eyes are, whoo, I can't see that stuff. I try my best. So. All right. Listen.
And he sayat unto Yahuwah.
And did what?
And Yahuwah shewed him a ox.
Uh-huh.
Which, when he had cast into the Ma'im.
Tell him what happened.
The Ma'im were made sweet.
Which means the water became drinkable. These folks would go out here, they'd be out here trying to make sugar water. I mean, the water was bitter. Which means the water had something in it. To, you know, it had a repulsive taste. Does it actually make sense he put damn sugar in the water? But see, you start reading sweet, the folks will make a mess out of it. So he made the water where he could be able to drink it. That's all they did. This shit, like they got the Berkey, that's not impressive. These Berkeys are really not impressive. The same thing he did with the tree. It made sense to put the tree in there. Remember, the leaves were for the healing of the nation.
Right.
So putting the tree in there only made sense. Trees got leaves. Yeah. Bart, there are things you can put in there that can actually absorb and take things out. Just like water, you can put charcoal in it. So I mean, and being honest, just showing you his attributes. Sometimes you read it, this stuff had you comical. Because he asked water around here trying to drink sugar water. All he did was make the water drinkable. I'm not downplaying what he done, but I want you to think sugar in water is what he did with no tree. Okay? I want you to think about what he's doing. Let's see what happened.
There he made for them a statute and an ordinance, and there he proved them.
That's how he tested them. Listen.
And said,
what did he say?
If thou wilt diligently shama to the call of Yahuwah the Elohim.
Without diverting, going off. Now, let me ask you what's correct. Can we look up diligent, please? Then see, and I make a statement, start thinking. We never looked, I hadn't looked up. Let's say diligent, acceptable. Diligent, having or showing care and conscientiousness in one's work or duty. Industrious, hardworking, okay. So we want to look at in our work a care that we need to put in it, okay? Having a care, diligence, I thought would be more consistent, but looking at the care that we should put in, because you could do something, but you don't have a care in it. Y'all got it? Let me see if that's diligence, careful and persistent work or effort. Diligence, thank you. Careful and persistent work or effort. Different. Stay with this one. Appreciate that. Got to be persistent. Can we see persistent, please? I want to get this down to a lowest common denominator. Because I'm being honest with y'all. A lot of stuff won't hurt. If thou be diligent to serve the Lord thy God, thy Jesus, and thou shalt go, thou shalt not. And you just recite and you hear it. You don't really understand what he's asking you to do. Now in your mind, when you don't know, you have to make up what you think it is. And that's what he then wants to do. He told me, no man going to serve no more. We're not going to serve no more. A man sitting around thinking supposed. Everybody going to know. He said, all going to know me from the least to the greater. That's why these little kids getting taught. Before a kid, the stuff they can recite and come back and they listen. And right when I was a kid, I wasn't thinking about writing that down. Paying no attention. That for old folk. I don't go to sleep. I don't go watch cartoons. But what he told us he's doing, all going to know me from the least to the greatest. Okay? Persistent, continuing firmly or abstinently in a course of action in spite of difficulties or opposition. That's what I'm doing, being persistent. Regardless of opposition. Kind of the same way we looked at with patience, endurance, going through without giving way, regardless of. That makes a difference, regardless of. I could do it if someone... No, regardless of. In the book of Marshall Lee, he talked about a slothful man. You ain't gonna believe what he'll say, Boston. He said there's an Ari in the way. He makes an excuse. He talked about just like a door on the hinges. He said, so is that man. He making excuses. That's what he taught in the book of Marshall Lee. He said, what a slothful man say? He said, claim there's an Ari in the way. He'd be jealous. You take a door on a hinge, you can swing that door much as you want to. That damn thing ain't going nowhere. He let you know, don't even try to think about it. Don't waste your time with him. So for us, we had to be persistent, continually, firmly, obstinately in a course of action in spite of difficulty or opposition. That's something a lot of y'all have been doing. Okay? That makes sense. Now, did we understand that? First thing we start looking, we got problems, we got hell, we got other stuff. He said, I want you to be persistent in spite of. One person we left who did that was Yahushua. In spite of difficulties. In spite of opposition. Everybody, he always had people opposing him. He always had people opposing, but he never let it stop them. That's how powerful the writings are. But when we hadn't looked at it that way, we tend to quit. You got to really use this. You got to really use this. I struggled a lot of years of wondering when my biggest thing be, I was always wondering when my fall was coming. I did. For a lot, I wondered when my fall was coming. When I was going to mess up. When it was going to be it. When I was going to mess up. Because people just constantly kept saying, you know, you can try a little bit. It's going to, but you know, it's just a given. So people try to set you up to already put you in that way. You got to run out. You have to have a mindset on what you're going to do. And you know, it make you think that you can't. That's a lie. You can. It's choices. Just like you make a choice to do, you make a choice not to do. Y'all got it. I don't care how much opposition, you ain't going to make me eat no mayonnaise. I don't want to eat it. Well, if I can resist that, how you going to make me commit fornication? Make me commit adultery? If that's not something I want, I don't have to take it. Then I can resist. He showed you got the will. How many of y'all got something you hate? Or food or something? What you got, Ken?
I don't really like mayonnaise too much.
You know what I'm going to make you eat mayonnaise. I'm opposite. I'm put it right here in your face. You got to eat it. Because that's not something you like. You don't desire it. Well, that's why you have to get, when it comes down to kata'im, you have to get to a point that you don't desire it. You can lie to yourself, okay, somebody come try to make me drink some whiskey. I ain't going to drink it, but you still like it. So what you do, what kind of shapes you to get away from it, you got to start looking at the detriment of it. From nature, natural, what happened to vision, look, it kill brain cells. It really does cook brain cells. It actually damages the brain. It's cirrhosis of the liver. But then you start looking at where it puts you at when it comes down to Yahushua, to Yahuwah. Even they talk about, even when it came to wine, he said it was a marker. And strong drink is raging. He said, whosoever deceived thereby? He said, not wise. He say you're not wise. If you let it out, because if you drunk it, and man, I got drunk, then you got deceived, which means you're not wise. And the people of Elohim, we always made our making on the fact, he told us, we were a wise nation. We was a wise Gui. Because our Torah, it made us wise. Even with the Rechabites, when they sat down and poured the wine, what did they do? Guess what? That was their wisdom and that was their understanding. See, you know how we're supposed to draw people? By our wisdom, our understanding. You'll come tomorrow and go with me. I was going to go. I got some shopping I need to finish. I can't do it. Why? I keep the Shabbat. I let people know why. I don't tell people that. I let them know. I said religious reason. When the sun, I let them know. I want it be some. No, I let them know. Sundown. Religion. I make them out. These folks don't mind telling you they little worldly shit. I'm gonna go bang some hole. I'm gonna do them get drunk. And sundown to sundown. I observe. I saw them do no work. I want them to know. They might not show up. They thinking though, why? Everybody else go Sunday. Sundown to sundown. I tell them Sunday I'm free. I hear some people that hit me and let them, they be like, man, I was in church. Give a shit about that. I saved your life. Ain't no pot saved your life. You should got your ass out of there. But you got to make sure you know what you stand for. And so now we start looking at this is our wisdom. This is our understanding of Elohim. Like he said, I came to prove you. So you'll know me. Okay, but I go, when he asks, I do it. You have to be persistent. Because all of the benefits of Elohim, we tend to want them because we pay our tithe. I open you up a window. You think this is all you got to do? You don't have to keep it, nothing else? Because in that writing, you go back in the book of Malachi, they call Malachi, he taught you in a way about a man dealing treacherous with his Ashar. He taught no more issues than that. He told you about going and seeking Louis. Because he said, because the people should seek the Torah at his path. Hello? So the other things he told you that will entail with you paying your tithe. When people go, Lord, say you pay your tithe, he'll open you a window to heaven. That's all you got to do? There's some other things that need to be entailed as well. Okay? Okay. Let's see. So I appreciate that. So remember this, continually, firmly, or obstinately in a course of action in spite of difficulty or opposition. I like that. Okay, we can go back. 26, listen. 15:26, Ula Shemut, they call Exodus. Listen.
And said, if thou wilt diligently shama to the call of Yahuwah, the Elohim.
Listen to the sound, Elohim, with the intent to do. What happened?
And will do that which is Sadiq in his own.
If we're pleasing. That's right. Which is going to be right if he pleased with it.
And will give ear to his Amar and keep all his statutes. I will put none of these diseases upon thee, which I have brought upon Mizraim. For I am Yahuwah that healeth thee.
Guess how they got to see it? Even with what he did with the Maim. He healed the waters for him. Hello? There he will prove and show him what I could do for you. So now you got to look at this. If I seen boils start coming on my body, that's really odd. These kind of look like the boils that was in Mizraim. What would I start correlating? Hello? One keeping his debar. What you say? I can't hear you. Well, my behavior is going to come in when I start to look at the Torah. Because typically, you know, if people that got medical books, you know, you can buy them, you can go through if you find something. I remember that people buy the medical book, you can go through if you got certain ailment, you can read, it could tell you what you got without going to a doctor. Y'all familiar with this? How many of y'all familiar? Had one or no people had them? Have you can look through if you got certain things. That's what doctor. All they do is they look through a book. That book, by certain different things, you start narrowing down. Yeah, certain things you start narrowing down and you come to your conclusion that we're going with this is what you have. You contract it. Well, how did I get it? Basically, people contract this from certain or contacts of other, or it's just a normative. All right? Now you come along and you start looking at these different things that you saw, and it was the same thing you seen in Mizraim. I started looking at, I have been persistent. I let opposition get in the way. I let other people oppose me, and that stopped me. I wasn't consistent. See how now, you know, oh, Lord, trying to kill me, trying to take me out. I'm trying to get you to consider. You saw this in Mizraim. You're not in Mizraim, and then you see it on you. What does it tell you about yourself? that your behaviors are the same as theirs. And I afflicted you with the same ailments to let you know. To let you know. Now, if you want to get a cure, come see me. Come and see me. Because you understand? For I am the Yahuwah, the Elohim, that hello? That's what they do. So now, not only am I the person that just, that Yasha delivered you from Mizraim, when you got yourself in another tribulation, situation, I came back and I afflicted you to get you to come back to me. You know, I got you through tribulation and affliction. That's how I got you. Did y'all know that? When you was in Mizraim, you were crying like a baby. You was. Didn't y'all know that was similar to a woman being in birth? The prongs, the pain, the different things, the travail she went through. That's why he got them out after you were born. I took you through that. I brought you through. I brought you out, just like a doctor deliver a baby. You call what? You know what I'm saying? Somebody, a woman will say, you know what, that's Dr. Sessa, the one that delivered the baby. Hello? Because they coach you through. Breathing, push. Yeah, right, telling you what to do. And they bring, that's like what? And the woman cries, she sweat, all these different things she go through, but the doctor helped to deliver. And that's what he did to us. Hello? He's a deliverer. He's a Yasha. So you just have to see him through like that. You had blood there too, blood and water. A woman get up too, she have a baby. He was birthing you, you just didn't know it, did you? That's why he was calling you his son, his Ben. He told you what I did. I delivered you from Mizraim. I birthed you out of Mizraim. Huh? I did it by all these signs, by all these wonders. That's how I brought you out. Hello? Huh? Okay. I guess it depends on where you at. So now I want us to consider these things simply because now we have to look at when things happen to us and they're similar to Mizraim, it's only because we have shown the behaviors of.
That's right.
And because we have knowledge of what Elohim prescribed for us, now we can do like somebody did when they had a medical book. We can read through, look at our ailments, and realize, that's what I got. What you got? I got the Mizraim. I got the Mizraim. Why is it so dark on me? Seems like darkness been on me for a long time. Why can I remember darkness being for a long time? You got a case of the Mizraim. And I put this on you because you stopped being persistent. You stopped being consistent. See, we didn't know how to, see, you can diagnose your own self. Why is what Shaul would tell you to examine yourself? What was I going to use to see whether I was in the arm or not? I got water that stinks so bad I couldn't drink it. They saw that in Mizraim. The water stunk. Not only was it dumb, it stunk. You couldn't drink it if you wanted. It stink. It smelled so bad. Then Yahuwah came along, he healed the Maim. So he got this out. He said, now, if you'll be persistent, consistent in everything I tell you to do all I tell you to do, I won't put none of these things on you that I put on Mizraim. See, not only did he come and afflict our enemy with it, he came and let us know, I'll put this on you because you'll become my enemy. I was an enemy to everybody that was an enemy to you. So now you turn against me, you become my enemy, and I'll afflict you. You saw what I do to my enemies. So now I'm going to look. When I start seeing boils, I start seeing hell come down and fire. I start seeing gnats everywhere on me. I start seeing all these things happen. This is none other. And Mizraim. And this has only come on me because I've become an enemy to Elohim. So now I want to come back and get in Elohim's con. See, a lot of times you just keep praying. He never told you to pray about it. You got to turn first. We start trying to turn. You need to look at the book and find out exactly and see for yourself. You got a case of the Mizraites. Hello?
Yes, sir.
He told you what they do. They'll sleep with their nearest of kin. They'll do all these different things. He lets you know all these behaviors about them, so you know that's the Mizrites. We don't do that. When we do that, we cut Tyre out of here. You become his enemy. I'm gonna be an enemy to whoever you're an enemy, whoever an enemy to you. But now you turn against what I told you. Now you just became my enemy. So all the things you seen me work on them, I'm gonna work them on you now. They're gonna be you to get you to come back. Because you know the same one afflicted you is the same one that can heal you. Hello? Let me see. Civil rights era, what were they marching for? Civil rights, like what kind of rights? Equal to white people and being able to do what? Voting, education. What, integration? What else? Better ride the front of the bus, better eat in the restaurant, and they went to God. Who did they go to? Why? That's who was afflicting them. They went to the white man. That's who took it from them. That's who allowed to have it. They went to the white man. Well, who got your health? Who got your strength? The same one that give it to you, the same one take it away from you. Take it away from you. Just like Jaheed and MJ say, the same one that took you out the mud will put you back in. He'll put you right back in it. Who can do it? Who can do it but Yahuwah? See, a lot of stuff we never consider like that. We don't ever think about turning the man with our whole law. We talk about that serving with our inward parts. If you're going to try to get delivered, then you got to understand what you're trying to get delivered from. A lot of it is yourself. It's a consciousness you got and a conscience you got. See, what we use to decide right and wrong, a lot of times what he use. All your fears and your phobia, they been giving you like he told you. Hope you guys see that Mark, the 7th chapter, 71. I'm trying to, Yahuwah willing. I know y'all human. I know y'all need to get some understanding. I do too. Because a lot of stuff going on, we just pray about it. You can pray about it. That's not going to work unless you turn. He said, if my arm, which are yakar by my shim, which are called by my shim, yakar by my shim, will humble themselves and what else? Palah, and seek my faith. And then, you know, I prayed the Lord last night about the stuff I've been doing. That's what we do. I've been praying to him about it. And you don't know why you ain't got no answer. Because you never turn. Mm-hmm. You gotta turn. It's directional. It's a direction. That makes a difference. People don't think direction make a difference. In the 9th chapter of the book of Oriah, Yahushua was coming through a city. And you know they weren't receiving. Because their face was though he was looking toward Jerusalem. He don't want to be him. I don't want him here. I could tell by your face you don't want to be him. And they didn't want to receive him. His Shalakim asking, without among us that we command fire to come from Shammai and Kasuma? The people could tell by his face. That's not where he wanted to be. His face was though he was going to Jerusalem. So why are we trying to receive him here? He don't want to be here. Now, if normal people, average people could pick that up about him, what does Elohim pick up about you? The writer told you his face was though he was going. They picked that up. Therefore, I don't even want to be bothered with him. He don't want to be him. I don't want to be bothered with him here either. Think of how many times you've been out of the way. Think of how many times your face has been towards something different. Like actions. He wants you to do something, but your face is toward, your mind is toward. Like that song? Your body's here with me, but your mind is on the other side of town. You're messing Yahuwah around. You know who you are. See, you could be someplace, that's not where your mind at. That's why he told me serve him, should call him, adore him. I want you to, like, we know should call, fall down, worship. He said, no, it's like adoring. You know what I'm saying? When you really care for something. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Then you show this obvious toward. He said, I want you to do. I want you to shakar me. I want you to adore me with your mind. I want you to love me with your heart. I want you to love me with all your inward part by making sure all those things work toward being toward what I want. Hello? People did things for him. Even a man, you think about Yahushua, a man kept a room that whole time for 30-some years. I don't know if he kept it the whole 33, but I know by the time he was accounting, he kept it, and he never let nobody occupy it. What kind of a hub you have that you keep that? Surely somebody came through need a room. Somebody injured. You know what I'm saying? Just need somewhere to lay down for a little bit. I don't even want to stay long. I just need to lay my head down somewhere. It won't be there. I'm keeping it for. And you know what? Eventually he came. Now, you're supposed to be keeping your inward part so he can come and dwell in it. That means nobody else habitate there. Because eventually he's going to come. Hello? Another man kept a donkey and never let another person put a burden on it. Donkeys are known for carrying burdens. No. Yahushua said his was easy and it was light. You know what donkeys are known for? Now, Jeff, more people don't know they can be used for protection. It's the fact they can carry a lot of weight. Did y'all know that? It only made sense you refer to Yahushua similar. They may have to carry the weight of the whole arise. They're known for their strength for carrying heavy weights. Hello? It only made sense that you had a writing about a donkey. Hello? And because of what they're known for, that's what he did for us. We knew about it from a carnal state. Then we got to see him actually work. It all made sense. Y'all got it? And all these things you need to consider. You trying to go somewhere and do something, and all we've been taught is, you know, you do something wrong, you just pray. That's all you do. Pray, ask the Lord to forgive you. This is bad information. You would turn for you to humble yourself. Can we see what humble is, please? I would say it two ways, Pastor. I want to see it from English, please, and if I could see it from the Aborigine, so we can get the understanding. You know, it would even talk about a man humbling. It'll tell you in certain writing about a man humbled a woman. He put her in a position, she got into a defenseless position. Y'all know that? And that's how we supposed to be when we come to Yahuwah. When we pull out, Shaul said, I will the unashamed pull out everywhere. Similar humbling. Put yourself in a non-defensive position. And you know what happened? You can't be humble if you commend Katah. That's defensive. Having or showing a modest or low estimate of one's own importance. We'll take that too. A low social, administrative, or political rank. Humble. A modest pretension or dimensions. Blur. Okay. Having or showing a modest or low estimate of one's own importance. And he wants to humble ourselves. You think about this. That makes sense when he talks about humbling ourselves. Because a lot of times why we do the things we do because we feel like we are important. That is, we do feel like we're important. I mean, understand when I say that sometimes our understanding about it, and it's not dropping our confidence about who we are, but it comes down to Elohim, he wants to drop the importance about ourselves. So we can take on the importance of his word and allow his word to make us. Hello? You think about a man should understand it, and especially a woman on both ends, because she had to come along, she's been a self-made woman. She's been her own person, and as she gets married, she had to come under subjection of. Somebody had to rule to make the decision. She was just constantly just made. She had to go and say, well, let me go ask my husband. You're like, what you got to ask her? Well, I'm married now, so I can't just go. How many women remember the start of that? Before you do, you had to go and I had to ask everything is free before they try to figure out. You got to ask him for everything you want to do, like you're a child or something. But then it was to get you to understand with Elohim. Before we do, we had to look at my importance. I have to drop that level of that because I'm under somebody now, under the authority of. And I had to give account for. Y'all got it? And a lot of time we don't understand it that way. That's why we make so many mistakes. That is, we should be considering before we do things. We need to consult it. Because you're not your own. The book declares you bought with a price. Now, let me say this. Not everybody. So don't feel bad when you ain't asked. He ain't purchased you. You couldn't be bought. See, that's the thing we got to look at. Understand that he want us to think about it. What we find in order, and that's second, they got Beth, Dabari Hayamin, Second Chronicles, they'll call it 7:14. If my arm, which are Yaqabai my Shem, will humble themselves, Palau, and seek my Pani. And you know how you have to seek his Pani? You have to get in where he looking. He never stopped looking one direction. So the first thing you do, if you get on 285 southbound, and you should pick him up. You should be able to look him dead in the eyes. He not looking southbound. He not looking westward either. Nor is he looking to the north. He don't give a damn about Santa Claus. He only looking to Kadim, which is the east. So if I'm going to seek his face, what direction? Well, you know he everywhere though. But now he told me to seek his face. Where's his face gonna be toward? The east. You see how we do things? Just go in your closet and close the door. I hope the damn thing locked. I hope it's locking on open back up. Bunch of them. I hope his shoe get caught in it. Cause people, we run off this. I know some folks did that pray. I had some folk were fighting and they start teaching itself. I had a lot of folk over in England. If folk did something. Boy, I got put out of there. That damn tired. The boy was going in the closet. He would close the damn closet, going in and pray. He said, come pray. The boy was going in the closet. Because he took me, who said about going in your secret closet? These English words, they take it and make a damn fool out of themselves. So daddy got tied him in that damn closet. They just fell out there to put him out. And he was fine. Tell me, who been with me for years? When I taught y'all go in the closet and close the closet, pray. These folks here, damn, take off. You not following me? And them funk ass clothes, your dirty clothes in there. I don't keep their dirty drawers in the closet. Don't pray in there. That's an ass prayer. No, that's the butt end of things. But see, people run and take off and do stuff, and he thought he had it. It didn't take long to fall away. Don't take long people fall, because people won't sit and take the time. Y'all got it. This man wants to humble ourselves, and we understand what it is. Humble, having or showing a modest or low estimate of one's own importance. The first thing, he won't kill my craft. I ain't gonna let anybody pull me down. This ain't about pulling you down. It's about getting you to understand. And really to do what Elohim wants you to do, you have to see yourself in a lesser light. That's why a lot of people won't stand. A lot of people won't do it. To them, it's beneath them. And you don't realize you beneath Elohim. He's not beneath you, he above you. Now he told you when you pull out, you say, I be new, which are in Shamayim. I'm in the heights, I ain't under you. It's important for people to understand that. I need you to have a lower estimate of yourself. You just need to come down like we said, get off your high horse. That's how I want you to know street strength. Get off your high horse. Because it's hard to do what he tell you to do when you got it. There's a lot of things we'll let get in the way, and it will hinder us from doing and a hobbing him with everything we got. Things will take things from you, will take what the ability that you have to do what he wants you to do. People will take away the ability you have. These can be oppositions. Your health. Wanting things, desiring things. I'm telling you, a lot of this, it can hinder you and it become opposition. You have to be on a constant of looking at things you got to make sure they ain't got you, even people. You do. You got to be able to make a clean break. And any time he tell you to break, you got to break. We talked about Luke when he would come out of Sodom and Gomorrah. Now, he procrastinated, hesitated like most of us do. But the book let her know what you who it was, what he was. He was calm. Yeah, right. He was calm to him. God, he could have left him. The fact, you know, you had to sit back and think when you get out and you look at that and look at that man killed all them people. That could have been me. Because I was moving. And they said, why he linger? We'll credit Luke for being brought out. Luke would have did just like some of hell, some of stuff we supposed to do. We working on it now. Been working that damn thing a long time. It ain't fixed either. Anytime you're working on something, it ain't fixed. I'm working on it, and you'll say this shit at door is fixed. Can't be fixed. If you're working on it, if it's done, you can leave it alone. Like Yahushua. He was working on it the whole time with him until he said it finished. Time mean complete. I'm telling the point. Like he said, because the thing concerning me got to end. That's what he said. It got a completion date. You got one too. But you ain't going to ever accomplish what you need to do unless we understand what is he trying to get us to see. There's a reasoning why he used certain words and then how they looked at what he said. What did they know about what he would ask them to do? We'll look at the operative meaning of humble. I want us to know the English part because we speak, unfortunately, as do all our people. They all speak their captive language. Well, that's why Yahuwah said he's going to return us a pure language. That's the truth. You got to do it. You can't return one to an undefiled, untainted. And these folks ain't got it. I don't believe these people tell them. No, I don't believe these people. Folks can't damn say it. Oscar Mayer. Stop spitting up all your clothes. Now we're looking up humble. Oh. To depress, to humble oneself, a publicly humble one another, to intimately humiliate, euphemism for forced sex, when they were talking about they would humble them, intercourse or rape. It would say humbled. I think it says Shechem, he humbled Diana. Y'all familiar with that? Yes, the daughter, which was the bath of Jacob, he raped her. The book says such a thing shouldn't be done in Yasharal. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yahuwah was raped. All these guys be looking, oh man, be molested, you're a punk. Yahushua was molested. They took his clothes off of him. And they thrust him through. Wow, it's crazy. That's what people want to think about. They humbled him. The book say he became humble, even unto them too. Y'all didn't know the book. According to writing, they did. They say he humbled himself. Even to the two. And people be like, so much stuff happened, they can't get over nothing. Listen, this is life. With everything that happened to you, everything that happened, things come in for a reason. People don't believe it happened for a reason. They ain't saying, oh, I set myself a track. And no, things happening for a reason because Yahuwah wants to formulate a different person than what we are. Don't you know all of us have different things that happen in our life and everybody got to break past it to focus on what we're supposed to do? You can let your past run you all the way to straight to just disaster. Anybody ain't went through nothing. It's impossible. Everybody had to be molested, but everybody go through some trauma. Everybody deal with it. Growing up without a parent or no parents. Growing up being molested, growing up with both parents and they junkies, growing up having to, you know, beg for food and different stuff. It's all type of different trauma people have. Illnesses or whatever they had, having to grow up and had to take care of their brothers and sisters and had to take care of a parent at the same time and just the trauma of dealing with that and having that stress and not being living life. Everybody deal with something. Get over your ass. Yep. It's life. Suck it up. You can pay a bunch of money and go ask somebody to tell you. I'll take you. You want to pay me? I'll take your ass around the world. By the time you get broke, I say, oh, yeah, he go to Elson. You know, ran out of money. He go to Elson. He like, thank you. You're welcome. I'll give you a graduation and everything. Get you a camera. Dun, 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 dun. Put them cords around your neck. I just tie one in. You just have one hanging out here. I said, anytime you feel like, I said, take it and hold it up as high as you can. And close your neck. Let it hang your damn self. Isn't that right? Then you get better. That being honest, people, you could let your past absorb too much of you. You can. This is life. There's nobody you gonna see in life ain't got no trauma. It's all about how you handle it. Everything I've been through, I can't afford to give wind to that. People say, well, what he does, he's subconscious. Shut your mouth. You know the hell I do till I tell you. I'm subconscious to do nothing. I deal with it like this. I don't tell myself no lie. Shit didn't happen. Oh, it never happened. It never happened. It never, I don't tell myself no lie. It did happen. Right. At the end of the day, what I'm going to do? I'm going to let it absorb me, take me out, and wear me out, and I'm going to lose a lot of time in life, or I'm going to have to move past it.
That's right.
I do have form. I tell people, like shit like this. I drive down the street, run over something, bust my tie, pull a sign of the road. Kale Khan Street behind, he run, bust his tie. Then Najee Khan Street, bust her tie. So eventually, when you get your ass over, start telling these folks, hey, watch out. Get over. It's something in the street. What we do is, everybody got to learn like I learned. My hurt was so strong, I want everybody to hurt. Then this is when you're a sick mother. You are a sick mother. That is. I tell Hale about that. I said, look him muff up. Somebody said, I said, you muff. They said, in. Again, I said, getting on my nerve. That way I'd be clear. I know what I said. Somebody else would keep the ENGs and the ERs and all that for me. And we just work together. We just harmonize. And I don't hear what he said. You know what? I'm sick of it. You know what, preacher? I'm sick of folks thinking of you. These clowns. He rough. People, they ain't heard it my anything. Folk don't know. Who that was? Jared, did you hear hey with my one down the phone? You got to hear for yourself. Did we take some abuse on that phone? Folk don't know what we deal with. Folk, you know they be thinking, oh, hey with a victim. Hey. Yo, other thing, hey, for let somebody victim around here. Hey man, I hang up the phone. He said, you know what? I'm gone. Click, hang up. We'll call me. We said, man, what's wrong with you? That man said, hang up the phone. We're like, what's wrong with you? Get strong. You gotta sit here and take this. I'll tell you, you think we enjoy this? No, this is to help you. I ain't get to talk to him the other night. Man, my state was so messed up. He did it to me again. I kept calling, I said, maybe if I talk him, his ass went else. He said, I smoked me a one and went to sleep. I said, he said, how you sleep? I said, I didn't sleep too good. I said, how about you? He said, I slept good. He went, he said, everything I wanted to say, y'all, I said it to myself. He said, I slept good. I told him, I said, I didn't like that. That just did something to me. Because now I want to know, what did you say to make you sleep good? Because I want to sleep good, too. I want to say it. Can I say a bad word? Can I say a bad word? That little kid lost it, then. I thought when you won. Mama couldn't even do nothing. But back to what we're trying to do. Intimately humiliate. And this is something we have to consider. Let me see something. See if that 2 Corinthians chapter 11. Let me see. Hold on. Hmm. See that 2 Corinthians chapter 11. Come on, everyone. Let me see. Never come to my mind, 2 Corinthians chapter 4. Let me see, 11. Not 11. Down to 12, 15. Let me try. One strike. Yeah. Okay. We'll go back up. Coming down. No, not 11. Go down 15. No, 16. We'll go 19. Let's see. 2 Corinthians 11, 19. All right, come on.
For ye suffer fools gladly, seeing ye yourselves are wise.
Listen.
For ye suffer if a ish bring you into bondage, if a ish devour you, if a ish take of you, if a ish exalt you, if a ish smite you on the pineal.
Well, if a man exalt himself, you said if a ish exalt you?
If a man exalt himself,
yeah.
If a ish smite you on the pineal.
Now, there's the man telling you about, he called these people fools. He said, you put up some shit like that. Amazing, that effect does on them. Somebody got a GPS, they don't know where they're going. 14:19, sin, go. Trying to get the root, ha, kadai. It's all right, Danny, we know where you're at. So then, listen what he told you. For you suffer if a ish bring you into bondage. If a man devour you, if a man take of you, if a man exalt himself, if a man smite you on the face. He talking about you, nigga. He said, that's the kind of shit you take. Listen.
I speak as concerning reproach, as mm-hmm. though we had been weak. Howbeit, wherein soever any is bold, I speak foolishly, I am bold also.
Mm-hmm.
Are they Abarim?
What are you?
So am I.
What else?
Are they Yasharal?
Mm-hmm.
So am I. Are they the seed of Abraham? So am I. Are they Sharoth of Mashiach?
Uh-huh.
I speak as a fool. I am more, in labors more abundant, in stripes above measure, in prisons more frequent, in moot oft. Of the Yaudim, five times received I 40 stripes, save one.
Hands. Tell them what? 39. 39 stripes, which your Torah taught you supposed to be the man. He told you that 40 supposed to say save one. That's why he told you save one. You couldn't beat your brother above 39 stripes. So that's why he told him 40 times. Remember, he said save one. He was trying to tell him 39. If I told you I got hit 40 times, then actually I would have told you they didn't recognize me as being an Aubrey. Remember I asked you, what they Aubrey? So am I. See, the stuff he telling you, all the stuff you would know if you know your Torah. That's why he told you 40, save one. That put you at what? 39, because that's the Torah. They did that to me five times. That's what he's trying to tell them. These people that you done suffered and you done put up with, that slap you on the face and all this stuff, you need to pay it up with us more than you put up with them. I've suffered more than these people have. I've done more than these people have. Okay? Let's go.
Thrice was I beaten with rods. Once was I stoned.
Yeah.
Thrice I suffered shipwreck. A Layla in a Yum I have been in the deep.
Listen.
In journeyings often.
Hold on.
In perils.
Hold on, we got blocked out for a second. Go ahead.
In perils of Maim, in perils of robbers, in perils by mine own countrymen, in perils by the heathen, in perils in the city, in perils in Bamadbar, in perils in the Yam, in perils among false Akim. In weariness and painfulness, in watchings often, in hunger and thirst, in fasting often, in cold and nakedness. Besides those things that are without.
Tell them what comes, son.
That which cometh upon me, Yum.
Every day.
The care of all the Adah.
Well, what he tried to look at, that don't stop it. He said he still, what he concerned about every day was the Adah, the flock, the fold. Regardless of all those situations he looked at, he endured, he suffered. Nothing took his mind away from his care for the Adah. You know, when you're dealing with all that stuff, that means he would have to humble himself. Make himself of what? Lower state, almost to no importance. He looked at, with all that going on, what would you be worried about if you got beat five times? 39. You exactly right, I'm gonna be worried about me. I'm out there shipwrecked. Who I'm gonna be worried about? If I'm out here and I've been robbed, in danger, in death, by my own people, by other Goyim, by false Akim, all these things happening, who you think I'm gonna be worried about? He said, still, this is what I care about. And you know how you get to that point? Making yourself of low or almost to no importance.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
And you know why we can't, and the reason why we're looking at this, because a lot of stuff that all of us are going to say we can't do. I can't do. Same thing I used to do. I can't do. And you know why I couldn't do it? Because I was not willing to make myself of no importance.
That's right.
This is what y'all need to know. There's absolutely nothing that he tells us, commands us to do that we can't. Why would I command, why would I make a newborn baby, command a newborn baby to get up and go in there and cook a five-course meal?
Right.
Why wouldn't it make sense?
Can't do it.
Impossible. They don't have the ability. Why am I commanding you to do all these things when you don't have the ability? So the writings came to do what? Teach you what things need to be in play in order for your ability to be able to manifest. As long as you have a great importance on yourself, you're not going to be able to do it. As long as you don't understand what how the writings are designated, okay? They're designated to keep you from quitting. Because I know you're going to quit. So I had to use some people that already got that aptitude to stay, to be firm, and let those people be written. So when you go through and read about these people, it then tell you, guess what? These people had the same likes and dislikes you did. Yet when they pull out, things happen. Because of these people, because of their willingness to look at, my importance is not an issue here. I'm concerned about, even when it came down to the Malkah Hadassah, what helped deliver us was her making herself of low importance. Hadassah was not going to go in to see the Malach or the Xerxes because he had given a decree that nobody was to come before him that haven't been summoned. If they did, they were going to moot. But Mardukhi, who had taken her in, had been like an Abba to her, who was her uncle, had told her the estate of the adult is on the line. There is a decree to destroy the whole adult. Now, if you don't do this, our deliverance, our Yasha, is going to come by another way. And you and your Abba house won't go blameless. Then she told Mardukhi to tell the adult, pull out for me. And if I move, what was her importance to herself? She was afraid it had never went in because she looked at, I didn't want to die. I'm a person of position. I'm a person people look to. And I'm not finna risk my life. That's stupid. But when he put on her the estate of the arm, when he let her know that if you don't, you're going to wind up suffering more. You and your whole house. She said, then if I move, I move. Huh? Why you think Yahushua was able to do what he did? Make no mistake, our deliverance would come if he hadn't done it. Had Moshe not taken the job, Yahushua still was going to deliver us. Make no mistake, nobody stopped nothing that man going to do. Look how quick, where they had to go. You notice when Yehuda fell, how they had to take somebody for 3.5 years and teach them? We never even knew that somebody had been there the whole time. You think that man, think about it. You think that man was sitting that way? One of the niggas finna fall. I can tell. I know when a nigga finna fall. I can tell. I'm watching this around him, but I think it's going to be that one. I ain't sure that the other nigga be real quiet, be up under him a lot. I'm kind of watching him. They just see him, you getting taught and going. And one day that man come here and everybody follow you and they say, which one of you that been with up front? All the rank we had, what rank we had that told her there were two guys that stayed there the whole time? Had been with them from the first time they started. Where we found out about them? Later. Found out they had been there the whole time. What were they telling you? Made no mistake. I got something reserved to myself. Any of y'all guys want to get twisted, don't want to do it. I already got somebody been sitting by waiting. That was good for me, let me know. Don't do it. I already got somebody waiting. Y'all got it?
Yes, sir.
Abraham didn't go up that hill and then got caught up then. Son, I already had me one in the thickest. Had you got up here and you didn't want to get that boy up, that wasn't going to throw nothing off. already had one that was caught up. Listen, that ram had no idea when he was sitting there, no doubt, grazing and grazing and going, that he had caught his, it caught his horns up and couldn't get out. You know what I'm saying? I'm keeping you right now. I got me one in the thickest. Y'all know that? Why y'all think Yahushua couldn't get away? You know how they kept Yahushua down? That's why they put that crown of thorns on his head. Where was he going to go? No more than that ram could get away. It was symbolic. This guy went, took some thorns, wrapped them up, and put them on top of his head. He couldn't get away. He was caught. Even he knew that. They caught me. I'm stuck. I'm the one that's got to go. Y'all got that? And guess what he had to do that? Make himself of no importance. Downplay my importance. Downplay all that I have and can do and look at humble myself. Think about when the men came on him at Thieves. Cup pulled his sword out, cut his shit. I ain't no punk. I know damn well nobody ain't putting their hand. I'll cut your damn hand. You hear what I say? You want when I cut your ear off? I'm just saying, I mean, real nigga from the street. Y'all start some shit? I'm gonna cut some shit off. Ain't that right? You started, I cut it. And then Yahushua had to tell that man, take it, put it back in his sheath. He said, you don't think I can palaver to the Abba right now? And what he'll do? But what he concerned about? What you got to do to be able to do that? Make yourself of little or almost no importance. All the stuff that we said we can't do, I start saying, I couldn't do it, I couldn't do it. Man, I can't do it. You could if you look at what he told you to do and how it plays a role in your salvation. Let me tell you something. I'll give it to y'all. I want us to be saved, all of us. I want us to get this right and get all the benefits that Yahuwah got for us. But don't y'all know, for all of us, include me, we're going to have to really get to understand by humbling ourselves. You know, the book even told you to humble yourself, therefore, under the hand of Elohim. And you know what he said, do? Why y'all think Yahushua's sitting on the right hand of Elohim? That's right. He humbled himself. So get what he realized. This is only for a period. You ain't got to worry about, I can't let nobody punk me all my life. This is only for a period. Listen, if you live now and die and you can't live again, that's all your life. If you live now and die and you're in Yahuwah, there's a life that's going to exist longer than this life. It won't be for all your life. The problem we got, we put our term only to moot here. There's a term, that's a term policy. Y'all familiar with insurance? How many of y'all got insurance? Well, stop. I don't want to know. I'm going to fuss about that. How many of y'all understand the two types of policy? You got whole life and you got a term policy. That's some other one, but typically you got a whole life and you got the term. The term is only for a period of time. That's your life. As is appointed under Sheen, that's called a term policy. Got it? After this, the judgment. Unto them that look to him shall he appear the without Kata'im. He's not coming back for nobody to commit Qatar. See, the first time we saw him coming, we were looking for somebody to come and ransom us, just like Musha. Even Musha coming, we already had an idea that they were going, because we had already been told that Yahuwah was going to yash us. Yosef told us, see, this is the problem. He didn't just pop up from nowhere. We were already told. He told us that Yahuwah was going to visit us. And when he does, he asked us to take his bones with him. So we already had to know we were leaving. We were just waiting. So you know we keep looking for him? Keep looking. And no doubt other people rose and looked there, but that's not them. That's why when Yahushua came, it was so important to question him. Because he did things that we kind of seen those before. He did things that we seen before. We had writings. He did things that we already kind of seen before. We've seen other people do makeshift things similar to what he's done. So, I mean, I don't want to get too sold on somebody until we know for sure. Y'all got it? People want to make sure this is the real thing this time. We actually leaving. There's a lot of right, a lot of things entailed. There's a lot of things we looked at, a lot of things we're trying to consider. And we just want to make sure that's him, so we needed to write it so we can examine him. To make sure this is him. Y'all got it. We don't, now you just, listen, if you feel good here, that's the only thing that matters. These are all dead tail signs of foolishness. Don't ever just go with something in here. What's in here has to get its conviction and motivation from the writings. Okay, you know what people say? Go with the gut. Don't do that. Gut got a lot of bacteria in it. That, okay, it does. Your gut has a lot of bacteria. So them feelings sometimes you get, you might need a laxative, a colonic. I'm telling you. It's a lot of stuff you might know. Don't go with gut, because your gut, ain't, unless your gut is centered from the debar, please don't use your gut feeling. Don't do it. And I appreciate that. You know how many other people got a gut? Are we going to be a bunch of farters in here? Now then, you go because you're going with your gut. Don't go with your gut got you eating shit you ain't supposed to be taking. Is that what we're going to use to follow? Hold on, what are we going to do? Hold on for a minute. We waiting on my gut. Why the man gave us the word? So we can use your gut? No, he gave us the word, and when we take it at what it says, we're supposed to get a conviction in here, in our inward parts, and in our mind, from what we know. Because what I know, some things you do, you ain't going to believe what you might say to him. What you doing? You ain't going to believe what I'm telling you. You know better. How I know you know better? Because you've shown the signs of knowledge of. Got it? So how you have to show you know him and your convictions and gut feeling, unless they can interline with what's written and what you know, those convictions, he let you know, now if that condemn you, all of him is greater. What hurt us for a lot of time we've been doing, our conviction been from them. They haven't been worded, it been from him. It's dangerous. The things that they told us and they got us off on. I appreciate the fact he brings us back to sit down. And like I said, all I'm trying to do is say, let's reason together. And then when he told, he said, come, he said, let us reason together. For once in our life, we got opportunity to make some reasoning out of stuff we've heard instead of just, let's just kind of keep going and just see where it takes us. I'm not interested. I'm interested on the amount, the truth. I'm interested in knowing it because I'm interested in being free. Y'all got it? So I'm looking at these things. I want to understand, what is he asking me, requiring me to do? You know, somebody humble, they just kind of be kind of quiet like. Did it say that? Be kind of quiet like. That's our definition. It's a person willing to be humiliated. You know, Shaul in 2 Corinthians, the 4th chapter, he talked about how they were made a spectacle. They were made a spectacle. They looked at all the things he was trying to tell us. They did all this, so they were looking at, we understand what he's trying to get us to do. And sometimes people say, you know what? When you be like that, people try to run over you, and people, I'm trying to get you out of that. I'm trying to let me use you. I'm going to take care of those people. I'm going to take care of those things. I need you to trust me enough. And where we at, I've been with you, we're not there yet. That's why we're trying to go over there. We're trying to consider. That's a lot. You just go, everybody be humble. It don't work like that. I got to get an understanding. I got to see how it's going to work to my resolve. What am I trying to get? What I'm trying to accomplish with this? I want to go somewhere so people just push on me and put their hand in my face and slap me? No. I'm trying to obtain salvation. And you know what he's trying to get me to do? I need you to get over your fear of how other people perceive you. I need you to get over how you look to people and trying to get the fame and trying to get the accolades of people. I need you to try to get a comfort level with me. I need you to get me to acknowledge you. And I need you to acknowledge me. When people try to figure, normal people, regular people, don't do that. Because I'm not regular, I'm not normal. All of him made. And that's what we're trying to really encompass. If we just come in, we just want to read some books. Hell, everybody just bring a novel. We'll sit out, we'll just play book club. Everybody just get up and read your section. Versus we get an understanding. If you're really trying to avoid Sheol, You got to have a real perfect understanding. Because you can have in your mind, it's too many things that come and work at you. As soon as you think you master one, it's another one coming. And you have to be so versatile. Y'all know, you have to be so, like the olive, you have to be so, how do you go from the strongest we got to you come down to giving your own self up? The olive could do that. Go from the leader to the teacher, to the feeder, to just take me. Just take me. I'll give my body for you. I'll give my body. And you know what? You can come inhabitate in me. The olive can do all that. Y'all got it. Now he tell you, as strong as you are, as you feel like you versatile, but you lose some versatility because there's some things you just don't know. Because you've never been put in that situation. You never had the knowledge of to know what you could do. So in a lot of ends, we've been limited. There's a lot of stuff people don't know they can do till you train them. And that's what Yahuwah been trying to do. He's trying to train us on how to do this. Because the logical mind, I'm not interested in nobody come putting a hand in my face. I'm not interested in nobody slapping me, spitting on me, or kicking me. I'm not interested in nobody walking, taking off my clothes, self or smitten. And she better have about 2 minutes turned up. Turn up! So when you have to think about where you at. When he asks you to do, where you at? How many of y'all game for that? Slap shit at you right now. Spit in your face. That's why I'm trying to, be practical. You a Christian. How many of y'all to raise your hand? We lied, because you don't look stupid. Preacher asked you a question. You ain't going to let you let Jesus slap you? Hell no. You either. I ain't interested. But we were taught a lot. Listen, if we're going to do this, the first thing I got to do, let's be practical. Okay? That's not where we at. So we need to try to go through and try to read and try to comprehend what this man is trying to get us to do. Because there's got to be a rationale behind this. Y'all got it. You're asking me to make myself of no importance. And the book says Yahushua made himself of no reputation. And told him he took on the form of a servant. Y'all know that? So everything we heard, we watched somebody going through that did it. Now, he ain't subjected to us, we subjected to him. You see the difference? But what had to do happen first? He had to come in subjection to. He had to come under authority of. Remember his mama told him to make wine? He told her, kick rocks. Did not. And much as he looked at it one at a time, what did he do? He was talking about his time. I assure you, I'm way too busy to be playing around with these damn drunks. I assure you, you couldn't even fathom what I got to do. We had to go right on ahead and let that go and go ahead and make it. Which means he did what? And he had to humble himself, make himself of no importance. I got to come on. How is Elohim going to use you? Guess what? And still stay persistent on what he had to do. What did that take away from what he had to do? What did that take away from him? You see that? Which means he was persistent. He didn't let opposition, he didn't let other things or obstacles or difficulties get in the way of what he had to do. He told the Abba to remove the cup. Why? It's not sweet. This is not good. That's how it's not good. It's bitter. It's sour. Just thinking about it, he had to realize something. What was it? My will is important. My will is important, but your will supersedes, override, I'll be humble. That makes sense? Yes, but see, if we don't understand in that way, he had things he wanted. There were things he wanted to accomplish. But now he looked at, it's time to do what the man want me to do. And if we can't reposition and we can't orchestrate to do what he told us to do in that manner, he can't use us. Can't use you. You have to be able to transition like that. Your feelings come up, your ideas, your wants, the things you want. If you can't, he can't use us. Y'all got it? The people he gonna make a seat for in the Mashkan, his Elohim, is the those that overcame. You know why? He said, because I overcame. He said, I'm gonna make them a place in the Mashkan, they call it the temple. He said, because just like I overcame, our biggest fight is ourselves. Everything stopping you, holding you back from being what he want, desired to do, ain't nobody but us. Nobody but us. Nobody but us. So we're looking to change that. Working on understanding, humble, what we got to do, putting, like I said, laying aside, and that hedges you, that fences you in. You know, a lot of us been fenced in a long time. It's time to come on out the gate. Y'all got it? Time to come on out the gate. And that's all I'll make sure we understand. Okay? Yes, sir. That's two. You said it.